Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Eat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Eat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up, beat 'em up. Wow. I got Reese's Puffs in my bowl. Wow. Now my day's on cruise control. Wow. I got Reese's Puffs in my bowl. Wow. And just like that, I'm on a roll. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Peanut butter chocolate flavor. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. In the AM, it's the flavor I savor. Peanut butter and chocolate too. You know how I do, that's what I wake up to. My Reese's Puffs inspired this rhyme. That peanut butter chocolate combination's on time. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs. Reese's Puffs, Reese's Puffs.
Welcome to the stream, everyone. Hold on, am I in the camera view? Why do I always start like this? Welcome to the stream. Hope you're having a nice Saturday night. Thank you for coming by. Big love to you, everyone. Hello, hello. Welcome. Chat, today we're on another date night adventure. I have brought on a lovely harpy dragon. It's going to be great. Hopefully you're having a nice night. Thank you for coming by, everyone. Big love to you. Don't be shy. Feel free to say hi. Yeah, we're just going to get into it today, Chad, because I don't want to spend a bunch of fucking random-ass time talking about bullshit until we get into the date. I'm excited. I had good sleep. Not really. I mean, I kind of did. I don't know. I'm full of energy, even though I didn't sleep that well. Maybe it's because the 8 to 8 p.m. stream. The 8 p.m. stream time gives me enough time to get food and energy and wash the porcelain joints, make sure they're not squeaky. It's perfect. Anyways, big love to you. Thank you for coming by. Big love. A couple hours doesn't mean I don't stutter and repeat my words. Anyways, the point is, the faster you say hi, the faster we get into the stream, all right? That's the idea. I got a lot of shit to talk about today with our guests, so, you know, we can have a good time and we can get into it. Teehee. Is father in a good enough mood to give us a date night chicky nuggy? What are you guys, hungry? Chad, you had 3 extra hours to go get your own food. Why do you need more? What, do I not feed you enough? I gave you exactly 1 Dorito last night. 1. You guys didn't complain back then. You had a wonderful time and you enjoyed it. I don't understand why you're so needy all the time. I don't get it. I don't get it. Hold on. You know what? I'm going to get you a picture. I have proof of you guys eating food. I have proof. How dare you all lie to me and pretend like you are hungry. Right here. Boom. Not that picture. Hold on. I'm changing it. Hi, Roy. Boom. You see that? Real proof. I took this picture yesterday while you guys were eating. The Doritos bag. This is why you're starving today. You ate the bag without permission. We're isopods. You can't blame our nature. Joel, why are you doxing us? Chat, out of all of you, 3 of you were found eating Doritos last night without permission. Do you have anything to say for yourself in your defense? Huh? Do you have anything to say for yourself in your defense? In fact, 1 of you is a fat ass. Look at you. That one's the one who ate the most Doritos, huh? You especially. Come on. 1 of you, open up. Who was it? Open up. Don't body shame. It's okay. They're isopods. They don't have brains. Come on! Okay, girl, I just showed up and he's yelling at his chat. Cringe. Oh, I'm sorry. This is what happens when people don't get enough food. They get angry. Do you see that shit? You came here, all right? I didn't tell you to. They just tasted so good, I couldn't help it. I'm gonna put that in the fucking notes later. I'm gonna write this picture down for the notes. If I don't find out who ate those Doritos, everyone's getting in trouble. I don't care! You want more of that sound? You better watch yourself. That's what happens to the isopods that eat the Doritos. Oh, fuck. Christ. I wasn't expecting that to happen. Anyways, welcome to the stream, everyone. Hope you're having a nice night. Big love to you. If you don't know who I am, my name is Forrest LeMaide. Because we got raided, I'll do my raid intro to start us off with. Welcome, one and all. My name is Forrest LeMaide. I used to be a sexy sack of man. Me before I died, my soul got trapped inside the body of a sexier female doll. Hey, in pronouns, but if you still use that pronouns in the 21st century, you can think of me as a bisexual's wet dream. Sexy male voice trapped inside of a sexier female body. I give you a curtsy. Thanks for the bits. Can I continue? Do you mind? I give you a curtsy out of courtesy, because Malgan is fucked like that. And Raiders, did you know that if you follow the stream, you gain 3 extra inches to your dick size? That's right, your dick will actually go from here to here. Talk about body shaming. That's a fat cock that you can get right there just for free. All you got to do is follow. Thank you for coming by. Big love to you. And let's get into date night, shall we? I think Tricky is waiting in the mansion for us. Let me get my hair nice and let go. I got to make sure I look good for this, all right? We got to have good standards. Anyways, Dirty Moth and Sandler, thank you for the raids. Big love, guys. Hope you had a good stream, and thank you for coming by for today. Chat, as a precaution, just so you know, every time you hear me say thank you to the any subs or anything, I will be muted, so I don't bother Tricky with it. But you can still sub and everything. In terms of, like, redeems, Monster Girl facts might be a little delayed. I'll get to them, hopefully. But if I miss one, don't complain about it. Just tell the mods, and they'll refund you for your points, all right? Everyone good? Got it. Buckle in. Let's get into it. You know where to go. It's time. Let's go. I'm walking into the mansion. Are you guys going to follow? Chad. Left. Go to the left. Guys, you're delaying the date. Left. I swear to God. If this is gonna turn out to be like that one time I took you shopping for new clothes, I'm leaving you. I don't care. I'm not going on the intercom again to tell my fucking everyone in the store that my chat can't find their way around. I'm not embarrassing myself again. Left! Thank you.
Okay.
Oh, wow, wow! What the fuck? And gave me indigestion. What are you doing? Tricky! I don't have insurance on this place! What are you doing?
I don't know! I'm sorry!
Put it out! Put it out! I don't have insurance! Stop!
I'm so sorry!
It's on fire! Tricky! It's already a shithole of a house. What are you doing?
I had a mishap. Okay, don't worry about it. Don't worry. I got it. Don't worry.
The cage is on fire. Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Dad. Go out. Go out. Go out. Go out. My fucking chat. They're going to die.
I'm sorry.
You're roasting them alive.
It's okay. Don't worry.
Use your powers. Why are you blowing? You have power. You're a drag. Suck it in. Pretend you're Kirby.
I'm working on it. Okay, I'm so sorry for what I thought.
They're gonna. Oh, it's gonna. Oh my God. There's one left.
Don't worry.
Oh my God.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Oh, no! Get it out! Throw it outside! Put it in the forest! Haruka can deal with it later. Oh my God!
Whoops.
What are you doing in somebody's house?
Sorry.
This place is already fucked up. My boulder could have been burned. My signature talking piece. The giant rock in the middle of the house.
I'm so sorry. It's good I did not do that.
Also, chat so could have been. You almost burned chat.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
They're like, they're gonna grow up with a fear of fire now. Look at them. They're like screaming. They're terrified.
Nothing wrong with a nice fire. It's me.
Christ. Oh my God. Having you on is a liability. I knew I should have gotten insurance before this happened. Chad, I mean, opening up life insurance on you.
It's fine. Don't worry about it. I fixed it. Oh,
my God. So
stupid. Holy fuck. We're going to get nice and hot and steamy.
My idea of hot and steamy is a lot different from being burned alive.
Oh, God.
I'm going to put that out there right now.
You never done a dragon before? Oh, you're going to have a good time then.
Where's the harpy part? What's the harpy part?
I'm a feather dragon.
That's pretty cute.
Has
anyone ever drawn you on a Yu-Gi-Oh card before?
Yes.
That's what I thought. I knew it. I couldn't be the only one with a good idea like that.
Yeah.
So you have a dragon tendency to like, I should probably start the stream anyways. Hey, welcome everyone to date night. My guest today is Tricky Wee.
Hiya.
With one eye.
Yeah. This Twitter has two eyes.
You know, I was writing that down for the tweet and I got so confused because I saw two eyes. I was like, that doesn't look right. What the fuck? Yeah. Tricky World War II. Hello. Uh-oh. Oh my God. But yes.
I'm on probation. I can't.
What? I just won't talk about it. Welcome, Tricky. The last time I had you on, you were here with Honey Goblin as like a duo date. And we talked about silly things and you turned into a baby for half the stream and you started making like Pokemon noises and it was really fun.
Wait, I turned into a baby?
Yeah, you were a little baby dragon for like the entire stream.
Oh, my chibi dragon.
You were small and you were going like, but like higher pitched instead of what I can do. It sounds like I'm choking.
Okay, let's get the best porcelain made screech.
You want to see how high my voice can go with that?
Yes.
I'll be honest with you. I don't know how possible this is. Ahem.
Wait, it didn't pick up for me.
Did you not hear it?
It didn't even pick up for me. Discord ruined it.
Oh, God. Can you hear how dry and dead it sounds?
Wait, Chad, I need you to...
Hold on. I'm trying to do it. You can't hear it over it. It's too low.
Okay, God, I'm going to unmute your stream so it can hear.
Ahem. Did you hear it? Did you not hear it?
That was good, though. That was good.
Try an E noise instead of an ah.
Yeah.
E. Is that any different?
Think abomination. When you think of abomination, then, you know, it just comes out.
Abomination. That just sounded deeper. Abomination. No, I'm yelling now. It doesn't sound high-pitched. Breathe in while doing it. Abomination!
Yes!
Oh, God.
Yes!
Oh, my. If I had a throat, it'd be fucking, like, shitting itself. Holy shit. God, I sound like a Microsoft sound voice come to life.
That was beautiful.
Oh, my God. Wait, hold on. What would Microsoft Sam say? Hold on. Right on your next destination. Oh God. I tried. Holy shit. Oh my God. God didn't create me with this in mind. In fact, I was dead. Is that what this happened?
That was amazing.
Why are you playing sexy sax? I'm fucking up my vocal cords over anything. Oh my God. Well, I'm glad to have you here, Tricky.
I'm happy to be here. Thank you for having. I'm so sorry about catching your house on fire.
It's okay. You know, I mean, it's already a shithole. Have you seen? Have you looked around? Here, let me move away so you can see it. Feel free to take a look. Yeah.
I think it's pretty.
You know, there's a boulder in the middle. I like that. It's actually up the ceiling. That's why there's a light coming down, but it just looks like a boulder. Then there's chat in the cage, you know? Uh-huh. They love it when people shake the cage. They think it's really funny. You know, the shrubbery is really nice. You know, it's good. Yeah.
This is comfy. I like it.
Some of the rooms are blocked off by rubble, closing off half of the mansion, but it's still good.
Where can my room be besides yours?
If you want, you can take the top left.
Top left.
Yeah.
That's
normally where a lot of stuff is.
I see. Okay.
And there's ghosts. There's no ghosts, Chet. There's no one else here besides me. Oh, shit! A ghost! Tricky brought ghosts, but there's no natural ghosts in my house.
Yeah, I got ghosts.
That's crazy. Look at them. They're so ooh-woo.
They're so ooh-woo.
Oh, my God. Do you think you could juggle them?
Yeah, watch this.
Oh! Holy shit!
That's the best I can do.
How do you not get seasick from that?
Practice.
I think you did. That wasn't even a 360 anymore. You went past the fucking Xbox One to an Xbox 4000. Yeah. Oh my God.
Oh, we just do a little spin juggle, you know?
Sometimes I see other VTubers try to spin, and normally it goes like, and then you come in and then you fucking, you act like, you turn into a fucking bottle on a table at a fucking teenager's party. Like, you spin way too fast for your own good. It's absolutely insane.
Do you have any spin the bottle stories?
No, I never went to parties because when I was a kid, every time I was invited to one, I would be like, actually, I'm going to go play Halo Reach online and record YouTube videos. So I'm good. You have fun though, idiot.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I would have invited you many times.
After a while, they stopped inviting me because I kept saying no.
Aww.
Yeah.
Well, you could have played like N64 with me.
Yeah. See, that's a fucking party. That's one that I would go to. We would pop in like Pokemon Stadium, and like we'd blow on the cartridge and fuck it up with our internal spit.
100%. So we always played Pokemon Stadium 2, Mario Kart 64.
Based?
And then the multiplayer for Donkey Kong 64. It was like you just ran away or like run all over the place and try to kill each other.
To be fair, though, I was only in the N64 era for a little bit, and then I was a GameCube kid because I was not fully conscientious. When do you gain sentience? At like 7 years old? At what point do you start sentience? Is it like 10?
I don't
remember anything before I was like 16.
I'm still an idiot. I don't remember half the things anyway.
What happened in my life?
I don't know.
Do you know that the VTuber boom was 4 years ago? It's like
really?
20. It was like 2020.
Oh, wow. I was so
it's
late.
Been, that's like 3 years ago now.
Yeah, I was
Can you believe
late.
It? This shit's crazy.
No, I can't, because I discovered VTubers in 2021, I think.
If we go back in time, I'd just... Somebody go back in time to assassinate Keys and I. Stop the VTubers from their source!
I feel like if I would have discovered VTubers a lot earlier in my life, I would be a lot happier.
You say that, but I discovered VTubers in like 2017, and you know, I'm here.
Oh.
Every day I start stream and there's a smile inside my heart, but on my face I'm just disgusted.
Oh no. I love VTubers. I love voices. I love titties. I love personalities. Yeah. I love everything. It's just hard to
I love VTubing.
Know.
I like the roleplay part of VTubing and just the people making characters based on their designs, and it matches their characterization of themselves, and it's really cool and interesting. And I'm just going to make out with every VTuber consensually.
Yes!
All the VTubers that allow it, I will make out with them.
Yeah, we've already planned that we were going to make out. We haven't done so yet, but we will.
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah.
The amount of people that I told them when I'm like, oh, I might go to this convention, and they're like, I love that reaction. I love that reaction when people do that. Even the cat girls.
You don't like cats?
I don't like cat girls. I love cats.
Oh, why don't you like cats?
Well, I mean, have you seen some of them? You seen the way Girl DM treats people? She's a fucking menace to society.
She was actually one of the kindest people.
She's a criminal. What are you talking about?
She was so lovely. Like, I was super
tired. She talks about her dad beating my ass every day. Every time I like make a minor flirt towards her mom, Girl Liam's like, my dad's gonna kick your ass.
Well, that's funny.
I'm just putting it out there. But what about
based?
She's still mad that I taught her mom the word bussin'.
You taught her mom bussin'?
Yeah, I was like, whenever, because her mom is a teacher, and I was like, you know, whenever somebody does a good job, just say, you know what, this is a bussin' good job. And Girl DM was like, shut up.
Oh no. Can you teach my grandfather these words?
Your grandpa? I'm not a gilf lover. I'm sorry. I start at milf and dilf, and I don't go higher than that. Unless they have like, unless they're in, like, their fucking genetics just don't allow them to age, then maybe.
But it's for the chaos. Can you imagine my grandfather bussin'?
Come here, grandpa. It's time to give you some new words. Do you want to hear about this new vernacular?
What does this word mean? What is poggers?
Oh, like,
I don't even know like Twitch slang either. So
sometimes if I catch myself saying Twitch slang out loud, I just slap myself on the face to stop myself.
Oh really?
Just immediate response like, no! Stop! You're turning.
I ordered food the other day, and I'm like, they gave me the food. I'm like, oh, thank you, poggers.
No!
And I'm like, wait, I probably shouldn't say that because they probably have no idea.
You should treat it like a zombie reaction. Like, oh my god, I've been bit, but I have to fight back the urge.
It's like, no, don't let the Twitch infection overtake
you. Don't let it take you over. Don't let the brain rot hold out.
But it's too powerful. I can't.
Oh god.
I'm changing.
Wow, you're doing it. You're really cool. Poggers. God.
You can't just stop it. You can't say, oh, I'm bussing.
I'm fucking. Oh, wait, no, that sounds weird. No, you can't say I'm bussing. That sounds different.
Oh.
That sounds a little different. Saying I'm bussing sounds a lot different from saying that's bussing.
Oh.
Ooh.
Ooh. That is correct. Oh.
Oh, God. Bussing makes me feel good.
Bustin'.
You know, in terms of music, I was showing Tricky this song that I found before the stream started, chat, and we found
it's a bop.
Oh my god. I found Kickback, which is the opening to Chainsaw Man, but salsa. And it's so good. I'm gonna actually play it on stream for them. They need to hear this.
Okay,
they need to hear it. I'm gonna play this for you. Hold on. I'm gonna play a little bit of it. This is too good to not share with everyone in the chat.
It's such a bop.
I've been listening to it nonstop. I've been shaking my ass all day to it.
Yeah,
oh, here it comes.
Oh, I hear it. Let's go.
Listen up, chat.
What a bop.
It's fully in Spanish.
It's amazing.
So damn. I can't stop myself from listening to it. Yo! Denji's popping! Alright. I gotta pause it. I'm gonna listen to this nonstop after the stream is over. I can't do it on stream. Here's the link if anyone wants to listen to it. It's so good. Me at 5 a.m. listening to it. I'm like fucking shaking my ass and the... I'm like cooking dinner while shaking my ass, and somebody out the window just sees me, and they're like, oh, what the fuck is he listening to?
He getting it.
He's going somewhere, that kid.
He going.
That man's losing it. Oh,
that's
my
the
God.
Best kind of music, though. And then, like, also whenever you find, like, the biggest bop, and then you're trying to go to sleep, but then it's just blaring in your head.
In your head the entire time. I'm just hearing the fucking dun 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 dun. I fucking, my legs like kicking in the bed. You know like how dogs will kick their legs when they're asleep?
Yeah.
It's me, but I'm fucking listening to music and I'm trying to dance in my bedtime.
Hey, bum, 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 bum,
oh, God.
The leg is feeling it too.
It's so good.
Yeah, like I've never heard this before. And
Oh, God. Are you the type of person to like listen to music until you get sick of it? Because I'm the type of person to just like leave it on repeat for 3 days in a row until I die.
I am the same way. Like, I have like my phases with like certain music where I'm like, okay, I love this song. Repeat.
Chad said this too. I don't listen to music. Like, I don't listen to it as a pastime that often. But when I do find a song that I really like, it's just on every day of my life. Like, I cannot stop. It's so good.
I don't know how people can, I come back to songs. Like, I'll get sick of it. And then, like, I'm like, okay, I can't listen to this anymore. I need a new song that I can be obsessed with. And then, like, in another, like, month, I'll listen to it again. I'm like, oh, yes. Oh, yeah. I missed you so much.
Like, I never get sick of something. I just, like, move on.
Yeah, exactly.
It's my hyperfixations coming to life again. God, I've had so many hyperfixations. I don't know if you do the same thing, because I think I have ADD. I think you have ADHD, right? We both ADHD. Hyperfixate a lot, right?
I hyperfixate everything. Like, if I...
Yeah.
It's really bad.
It's like, what do they call them? Phases? Now they're called hyperfixations. I had so many like children's toy hyperfixations because I spent like $300 on Bakugan before, and I was just obsessed with Bakugan. Then I spent like a fuck ton of money on fucking Slinkies.
Bro, dude. Okay. Went to Chuck E. Cheese. I wouldn't get anything else with the Slinkies.
Yeah, I like the Slinkies and the little sticky slappy hands that you throw.
Yeah.
You whip them around. Slap.
And like the squishy like God. Ball things, like squishing some balls. How many
every
balls
time I
squished?
Went, you caught me off guard. Why is this? It's funny because this is the second time a VTuber is coming to my stream to talk about fondling balls.
It's normal.
Yeah, apparently. Can you guess who the first one is? Can you guess who the other one that you're you? Can you guess who your soulmate is there?
Can I have a hint? I have many soulmates.
Food.
Food.
That's your hint.
Gary.
Yeah, it was Gary. Gary came into my stream and talked about fondling balls before. God.
Yeah, that sounds like Gary. That sounds like Gary.
You know what? I get it. Speaking of hyperfixations again, I got these balls called Bowding balls, I think.
What's a Bowding ball?
I think it's, I don't know, I might be bullshitting this, but from my memory, it is it's like a Chinese, it's just two Chinese really smooth wooden balls, and you just kind of like fondle them to like relax.
Oh, I want to fondle balls to relax.
I have them in my hand, you want to hear them?
Yeah.
Here, I'm gonna clap my hands without using my hands.
Do you have porcelain balls?
I'm not gonna answer that on stream. There you go. I'm not gonna answer that question on stream. That will not be answered today. Every genitalia that I own is in a closet locked away until I need to use it. As far as you're concerned, on stream, I'm a Ken doll.
But what about your big dick?
I mean, it's still big. It's just not on me right now.
Oh, I see.
They're detachable. I have like a line of varying sizes for whenever I'm feeling frisky.
You just attach it.
Yeah. It's like, there's one that's just like third leg, just for show. Please do not use, with like caution tape on it. It's so stupid.
Are there any for sale?
What, old ones? I'll give you a cracked one.
A new one.
Well, you can use it as like a weapon.
Oh, yeah.
There we go.
That sounds fun. That sounds fun. Yeah. I like that. That's like Dead Rising. Just get like a cracked...
I love the games that give you a giant dildo as a weapon.
Yes!
Fucking, I think Saints Row had that. And I was like 17 playing Saints Row. And I'm like, what the fuck? A whole new world.
A whole new world.
It was so good.
A whole new point of view.
A whole new porcelain point of view.
It's wonderful. I love it. I love it.
So stupid. I was going to ask you something. So, chat, I have a request for all of us, right? So, lovely Tricky, she's a harpy and a dragon. I was trying to tell Tricky, what if she could coin a word for the mixture of a harpy and dragon? So, with that being said, chat, do you have any ideas? How do we mix the words harpy and dragon together? Like, what can we make out of it? So she doesn't have to say, I'm a harpy dragon every time she introduces herself.
Well, again, like, I'm not like a
hargan.
Like a hybrid. A hargan?
That'd be cool.
A hargan?
Yeah, but I mean, even if you don't have to use it, but I think it'd be cool to like make a harlot.
A harlot?
That's me. Oh, a giraffe! That's so cute.
A giraffe's cute.
Oh my god.
Darpy.
A darpy.
A darpy. Hard on! I can't be a hard on.
Hi, my name's Trickiwee. I'm a hard on.
Oh no.
Welcome to my stream. Then you screech.
Welcome to my stream.
It's so good. Oh my god. I don't know. I love Monster Girls, so making up little names for them would be really cool for me. I loved it. Yo, Tempest! Where the fuck did that come from? Thank you for the 10K!
Thank you, Tempest!
I'm gonna use that money and I'm going to buy indiscriminate objects that I will not say online so the government cannot find my location.
More balls.
I'm gonna buy balls. I'm gonna buy balls for myself, yeah.
Yes.
I'm gonna buy those fondle balls for relaxation, I guess.
Yeah. It's like a built-in stress relief.
This is so stupid. Thank you for the immense amount of bits. I appreciate it. Oh my god. Fuck, dude. That was a
like
start.
Darpy.
Yeah, Darpy's cute. I think Drappy, Darpy, Darpy.
Drappy, yeah. Those
a little Drappy. Oh my god. You and me both do the same thing where I don't know if cuteness aggression takes hold of you, but it does for me. Like, I'll do little baby talk and then I'll be like, you're so fucking cute. And then I throw a punch. So I don't know if you do the same thing, but whenever I see something cute, I want to like punch it.
It's like, oh, you're so cute. Catches it on fire.
Yeah.
Well, not on fire,
you're so cute. Stop existing.
Yeah, it's like a triple backflip into you, and then like.
Do you have what's your normal reaction to when you see cute things?
I hug it until it die. Kidding, but kind of.
You just squeeze. Wait, yeah. Move your head, Tricky. Move, move to the left.
Wait,
sorry, I couldn't see it. Call Tricky a husky, and he gave me $50. Tempest gave me $50 to call you a husky.
Why the
How dare you? You think money runs this place? Give me another 50 and I'll do it. You
Don't.
Think I would do it for money? Give me another 50.
What?
I would never! I have integrity! This porcelain has no cracks in it for you to shove your disgusting, filthy money in! Tricky, I'm sorry. Look away. Tricky, I need you to look at me while I say this.
I don't want to.
You're good little husky. You are. Yes, you are.
Goodbye.
So what is this? Why is this a thing?
Because chat's rude.
Why are they calling you a husky?
So this started with Numi.
Oh, okay. I get it now. Yeah, no, normally everything starts with Numi. It's all Numi's fault.
It started with Numi. Yeah, we're like trying to figure out if we were dogs, what breed of dog we would be. And then so.
Why not a husky? They're cute.
I like huskies, but like. Now, every time someone sees a husky, they're like, look, it's Tricky.
Oh, it's just annoying, okay.
It's like they picked husky because they're loud and dramatic and screech.
It's affectionate. You know what I said Numi was? Because I had a whole TikTok that I think blew up, actually. Because
yeah, a golden retriever.
Yeah, a
me.
Golden retriever that's crying.
Yeah.
A sad golden retriever is how I see Numi.
Yeah.
And it's very cute. Because she has, like, the... Numi, every day of her life, looks like she's the pleading eyes emoji, like, incarnate. Yeah. And I've been saying this for a while now. Yo, also, Tempest, thank you for the 100 gifted subs. Much appreciated. Thank you so much. Urinescent and torture of your favorite streamer is giving me money, so I'll take it. It's not my problem. Thank you.
It's your problem now.
Oh, God. Shit, she's got a knife under the stream. You can't see it. I'll have you know that I'm resistant to slash attacks. You ever put a knife on porcelain? Wait, okay, Tricky, I have a question for you.
What's up?
I need your opinion on this because my chat is stupid, all right? If I say a pickup line, right? Let's say, yeah. Hey, babe, are you hungry? Because I got some porcelain that you can eat on tonight. Do you understand the pickup line?
I mean, well, okay.
Porcelain, you eat on porcelain plates. I'm made out of porcelain.
So you're gonna...
They eat off of me. That's the pickup line.
Oh, I just immediately thought of cuck.
No, why would that be a cuck scenario?
Not cuck.
Like cock, but you're saying it with the A-U-L-K?
E.
It makes sense, okay? I was chat, whatever. That dating show was rigged. That made sense. I don't care what anyone says. The pickup line makes sense.
I think that's...
I'm so mad about that. Did you get?
I'm sorry.
Why? Because a cock?
No, I'm thinking about your pickup line. Just all you want to, because I'm thinking of like a porcelain weenie. So like...
no. You're not eating the porcelain. You're eating off of it. You know, I'm not going to start the pickup line with like, hey, eat dick. Like, that's not.
No,
you don't pick somebody up like that. What, do you want me to fucking whistle at them and turn them to a wolf at the same time? Hey, baby.
Woo. Okay, my bad. Just kidding. Okay. So it's like a nice dinner.
Yeah.
Okay, well,
but they're eating
that.
Off of me because I'm the plate.
Ah.
So it's like sexy, but it's not like super crazy.
Maybe you should lead it off with like, you'll be their plate, their porcelain.
Yeah,
plate.
But that's not the. Hey, baby, are you hungry? Because I can be your porcelain plate tonight.
Yeah,
does that
see?
Work? Is that a better version?
I feel like I would have understood that a lot more.
That one better? Chat, is that one better? Heavenly, you have no Riz. L, Ratio, you're not even on the stream. Shut the fuck up. Get out of my chat.
Hi, Heavenly.
Don't say hi to him. Just ignore him.
What?
You aren't even real. Shut up. Shut your ass up.
Oh, you're holding some head?
Heavenly's a walking hypocrite. No, I'm done. Stop. Stop.
Can I hold yours?
No. Tricky. Oh my god.
I'm sorry.
You got them on screen. I got them sending me cat pics. Heavenly, I want you to know I'm on a date. What, chat, what's the dub here? Being in somebody's DMs or going on a date with them? Bro. I like fighting with Heavenly. I don't know why. He makes me angry. I like fighting with him.
I got the giggles.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We've been fucking giggling this entire time. Are you kidding me?
Wait, when was... yeah, you're right. How... Did you do a date with Heavenly yet?
No, I've had him on for Apex back when I streamed Apex occasionally, but I haven't had him on.
Heavenly date.
I can bring Heavenly on for a date.
Yeah.
He's going to instantly start a fight.
Oh, good. Yeah. Date.
There's a lot of people that I want to bring on that I know I would just like get into a fight with. Like Heavenly's one of them. Kenji. I had Giga on. Giga makes me angry. Those ones make me angry. I like the ones that make me angry.
I see,
think it's funnier.
Yeah. Understandable.
The ones good that content. Laugh easily are my favorite.
Oh. Don't look at me. Don't look.
Do you know what I mean? Sniff.
Not sniff.
You're my favorite because you're laughing. Oh, God.
You're my favorite deputy.
David Kun. I heard you like anime.
Oh, you're porcelain.
No, oh, God, stop. Oh, you smell like mothballs. Tempest, thank you for the 5,000 biddies. Tell Tricky I'm sorry. Tempest says he's sorry. But I don't give a shit. If you reject him, I'll probably get more money out of it, so. Say no. Say you don't forgive him. Say no. I'm turning into a capitalist.
That's mean. That's mean. Oh, I got nut on my forehead.
No! Fucking hell. I'm gonna sit down. I can't stand you guys anymore. I'm putting my standing desk in a sitting position. I'm getting in the chair.
I'm sorry. I forgive you, Tempest. Just never do it again. I'm a fucking eager asshole.
Yeah, don't do that. Don't do that. So silly. Mm-hmm. Anyways, we had more shit that we were talking about before the stream started. Like how we were talking about how this is Tricky's first favorite job and like this is my second ever job, even though because my first ever job was working at a Little Caesars, and that was enough life experience that I need anything else. My God, my first job is so bad. My chat already heard this a million times because every date night that I do, I talk about this. It's so. So one, Tricky, let me give you the rundown of my life at Little Caesars, working at a Little Caesars.
Okay,
one,
I'm ready.
My boss is a freak, right? My boss is an absolute freak. One, he's married. He's like trailer trash. He's married. He specifically went up to me once and he was like, you know what, Joel? You're one of the good ones in a racist way. He also would hit on random women that would come into the store and be like, pussy. And that's why I can't say the P word anymore because it makes me feel gross because of him. Basically, he's human scum, right? He would come into work every day like really high on something. And it was crazy. Anyways, that's just to give you the basis of what kind of person he is as an idea, right? So, one day we get a new worker coming in, right? We have a new worker. He comes into the store. He's like, he's just this nice guy. He's this really nice Latino guy. He's very quiet. He's shy. He comes into the store. My boss comes in an hour later. My boss says, hey, you, come with me. They leave. They go in the new worker's car and they drive off. I don't see them for the rest of the day.
Oh.
The next day, I go to work. The worker's car has crashed in the front parking lot and he never came back to work ever again. Never saw him ever again. The only time I heard about him was a month later or something, or like a week or month later. And the guy calls in and he's like, I'm not coming into work today. And I'm like, dude, you haven't come into work for the last 2 weeks.
Yeah.
I never saw that guy ever again.
What in the world?
I don't know what happened to that worker, but I'm like, what did my boss do?
That doesn't even make any sense.
Don't worry. There's a happy ending. A few months later, I come into work and I ask, where's the boss? I found out right before I came into work, the police came to the store and arrested my boss on the spot because he had been embezzling money from Little Caesars for 4 years without anyone noticing. He was stealing money from Little Caesars for 4 years. None of us knew. He stole money from me. I was like I kept putting in money for a new outfit, for a new worker's outfit because it was covered in the gunk that Little Caesars makes their pizza out of. And like for years, I go to work in this disgusting uniform and I'd never get a new one. Because he was embezzling. I went to a manager's meeting before, and the owner of the Little Caesars in the area, she went up to me and was like, why do you guys, I'm not a manager, by the way. I was just a worker, but they had me go anyways, just to get the information. But while I was there, she was just like, so you guys are always at a loss. I don't know what's going on over there, but you guys need to start turning a profit. No idea this dude was embezzling funds the entire time.
Oh my goodness.
That was my first experience with a job. That was my first job.
I'm so sorry.
It's good content. Also, Tempest, thank you for going absolutely insane with the 4,000 biddies, the 20 tier 3 subs too. What the fuck? Thank you so much, dude.
Chad, I wanted to say something, but you were in the middle of the
story. I know. I was like, do I pause right now and acknowledge that, or do I just continue? But thank you. You have a big dick, a big heart, even bigger wallet. Thank you for the generous donation. Oh my God.
Thank you for supporting my friend.
Thank you. I'll be putting this into my payment for Tricky since I hired her off of EPAL for this stream.
You're supposed to tell people that.
Oh. I'll be putting this into my wallet and nobody else's because I did not pay Tricky to be on stream with me. She is my real friend and I would never.
No. Never.
I would never pay for people to come in my stream. you know somebody's gonna think that's real. Somebody in the chat's gonna think that's real.
Yeah, I'm waiting for like the twit longer of like
Porcelain Maid pays VTubers, he's not real. Oh my God.
Lol.
It's so funny. So funny.
So silly. But oh my goodness, that is I'm so sorry you had to deal with your little boss man.
It's funny. I mean, when I was younger, I was just like, I was just like, he's a freak, but whatever. I don't really like him, but okay. It doesn't bother me. Then years later, I'm like, oh, that guy was really fucking weird.
Yeah.
As a kid, you don't recognize the signs of somebody being really weird. And then you get older and you're like, oh.
Yeah, that's very accurate. I had 7 jobs before becoming a YouTuber.
Fuck. And
Twitch person.
You have a lot of experience then in different... Is it like a bunch of different jobs?
Uh-huh. My first job, I was a housekeeper at a motel.
Oh, God.
And, oh God!
Not a motel. Not even a hotel.
No, it was a motel.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh God.
Yeah, I got the job because my grandfather was the manager.
Oh no! The one that you want me to teach bussing to?
Yep.
Our motel is bussing.
That's how I found out about, banging. I was like very, very, very innocent back then. I didn't really know a lot of things. I thought babies came from belly buttons and everything. So like, I didn't really understand a lot of stuff. But the protocol for like being a housekeeper, like you have to knock on the door and be like, housekeeping, to, you know, just make sure that no one's in like their room so you can go in and clean everything and change the sheets and the towels and everything like that.
God.
Let's just say that somebody did not hear my knocking because they're too busy knocking each other. So then I went in and then like, and
God.
Like, oh. And I'm like this kid. And I just like, I was like, I'm sorry. And I slammed the door and then I ran back to like the little office.
That's like traumatizing for everyone involved.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh no, what have I done? Like, what is happening? I'm sorry. Like,
God, dude. That's how Tricky learned about the dragons and the harpies.
Yeah, it was very embarrassing because I didn't really know what was going on. I just saw like titties and I was like, oh, I'm not supposed to see that.
I relate to that. I was a late bloomer and a bunch of kids at my school were talking about like, oh dude, boobs are so hot. Am I right? So I was like, I don't know what the fuck you guys are. What's so good about boobs? I go home. I get on the internet on the old like Dell PC and I look up hot boobs. Or I it was either that or I looked up why do people like boobs? And the first thing that came up was hentai. So the first thing I ever saw about sex was hentai. And it was like this roller rink hentai. And it was like, what the fuck is this?
I remember.
I was like, oh my God, I fucking get it! I get it!
I get why boobs are hot now.
Went to the school the next day and was like, what's up, boys? I've transcended. I get you. I understand.
Yeah, it's like, once you actually understand, then you go down like a rabbit hole. Because that's what happened to me as well.
God.
Because like after the motel business and stuff like that, I got into a website called Quizla. Where like you could just make like a whole bunch of quizzes, and it was before fanfiction.net was a thing.
Oh, Quizla.
Yeah, I was like, ooh, I want to make all my quizzes and everything like that. Oh, you got a raid.
Yo, let me do my, I'm going to speed run the raid intro. Do you want to time me?
How long?
It's, no, I can do it as fast as 23 seconds.
Oh, let's go.
All right. Welcome to the Stream Raiders. My name is Forrest LeMaitre. I used to be a sexy second man. Me before I died, and my soul got trapped inside the body of a sexier female doll. He and pronouns, but if you still use that pronouns of the 21st century, you can think of me as a bisexual's wet dream. Sexy male voice trapped inside of a sexier female body. Big love to you. Hope you're having a nice night. I give you a curtsy out of courtesy. Be smoking as fuck like that. And Raiders, did you know that if you follow the stream, you can gain 3 extra inches to your dick size? That's right. Your dick will actually go from here to here just by hitting that follow button. Thank you for the raid, Too Bold, and big love. How was that?
That was 25 seconds.
Damn it! Wait, I can do better. We got another one. Too Bold, thank you for the raid. Big love. And we got a raid from Audible. Give me a second. All right, chat, get the timer ready.
Okay, hang on. Let me reset it.
All right, I'm waiting. Ready.
Wait. Hang on. I closed it.
Let me get it. Don't make me laugh. I'm gonna run out of breath. Oh, bro, we're timing how fast I can do my raid intro, and you came at a good time.
Okay, go.
Also, Raiders, shout out to Too Bold and Audible or mods. Thank you. All right, I'm ready.
Okay.
Welcome to the Stream Raiders. My name is Forrest LeMaitre. I used to be a sexy second man. Me before I died, my soul got trapped inside the body of a sexier female doll. He and pronouns, but if you still use that pronouns of the 21st century, you can think of me as a bisexual's wet dream. Sexy male voice trapped inside of a sexier female body. Hope you're having a nice night. I give you a curtsy out of courtesy. He's mouthing as fuck like that. And Raiders, did you know if you follow the stream, you gain 3 extra inches to your dick size? That's right. Your dick will actually go from here to here just by hitting that follow button. Big love, Dean. Thank you for the follows.
25 again.
Fuck! Shit!
That was 25 again.
Maybe it's because I'm trying to make my voice deeper when I do the bisexual's wet dream part, so it makes it slower.
Oh, yeah, the bisexual. No, nice.
I'm trying to do it fast enough, but, like, clear enough that they still understand whatever the fuck I'm saying.
Yes.
Because I don't want it to be like fucking, like I'm an Eminem rap god slurring my words.
I like it. That was good. Big clap.
I'll do it. As long as people can understand what I said it. But yeah. Audible, Too Bold, thank you guys for the raids. I'm on a date night with the lovely Tricky Wee, professional Harpy Dragon, and professional Pokemon voice actor.
Oh, I am? I didn't know that.
Yeah, don't you know every time you make a Pokemon noise, that's the official noise?
Oh, it is?
It's my headcanon that you're the official one. Yeah, I'd say that's headcanon real.
Yeah, sure.
I say that's my headcanon that you're the official one.
Whoop.
Fucking love. I hate that stupid Pokemon, but I love his sound.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I love
love the Reggies in the movies. Reggie. Red. Reggie Rock. Reggie Eyes. Oh my god. Dude, that scared the shit out of me as a kid. It was so good though.
Really?
Yes, the Reggies in the Lucario movie when I was growing up. Reggie Eyes scared the shit out of me. I was like, whoa! Why does he sound like that? Fuck!
I love their noises. It's so fun.
I love them, and then Reggie Agigas makes me mad. It's just a man.
Hey.
Dude, it's just a guy.
Yeah, that's kind of what happened to a lot of, like, the newer Pokemon in the dub.
Yeah, the the Ultra Beast that's just, like, Aaron Hansen from Game Grumps screaming.
Just, ah!
Ah!
It's a Deathlord.
Ah!
I don't understand why they did that.
It's so I loved Electabuzz back in the older days. God, it's so funny.
I wish my titties would actually get some of that. I'm sorry.
Tricky.
Well, I kind of made it quick.
Tricky.
Okay, I'm innocent now.
If that does happen, does the ghost that's covering you up, do they blush too? Are they like, oh?
Nah.
What's that one's name?
He's a Booba.
Honey, sweetheart.
His name is boober.
That's like that's like getting a cat and naming it cock.
What? No! He gets the name because of where he hangs out. His real name is Ouroboraboo.
Okay, I'll take that. Ouroboraboo. That's cuter.
Ouroboraboo.
I like that. Mm-mm. I like
his
the name.
His name is Booba.
Yeah, I like that name. I like the name Orobo too. But yeah, Chad, if you don't know Too Bold and Orobo, Orobo is an amazing artist. They were doing fan art for Mousy, I believe, in the last stream. And Too Bold, really fun guy. He is a living fleshy man, but he's very funny. Go check him out. I've been getting into more hanging out with fleshy people lately, and it's so fun. It's so fucking weird seeing my model on the same screen as somebody who's like an actual live person.
Isn't it fun?
It's so goofy.
I think it's wonderful. It's kind of like a, you know, a cinematic universe.
Yeah. It's,
we're lots of different people.
We're mixing with them. It's not like we're also fleshy people that just use mascots or anything. That's crazy. Mm-hmm. That's not. That'd be stupid. Am I right?
I remember whenever I used to be a fleshy.
I remember back when I was alive.
Yeah.
I have an excuse. My lore is a part. No, it's not. No, no. No, not on my stream.
I got my nut on my forehead.
Not. Stop. Back when I was alive, since it's part of my lore, I can always just pre-emphasize things by saying, like, back when I was alive, and then I can get away with anything. Other VTubers just have to be like, I don't know what you're talking about. They just have to deny and deny and deny.
Yeah.
Pathetic.
Yeah. It's like, oh, back whenever I was a, you know, I did the human disguise things, you know.
Yeah, you have to make up different lore, like, oh, that was a flesh suit that I bought.
Exactly. That's just a disguise, because obviously a harpy dragon could be
I would never be 3D. That'd be ridiculous.
I'm already on probation. They can't catch me.
I was drinking. I almost put that on my computer.
Oh, don't do that.
Oh, my amazing. God. Excuse me, that is a paid service, thank you.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay, Tempest basically paid for you.
Oh. We love Tempest in this house.
Has Joel met Newville? Is that a thing? Who's Newville? Novell.
Oh, Newville. More Nazi.
Stop! I'm gonna move that up. I'm gonna move that up into the fucking top right of the screen.
No.
I'm taking away the nut.
No.
I'm putting it in the trash. Where it belongs, just like the rest of your disgusting. Never mind.
But I like the nut.
Chicky! You made the Drappy sad.
The Drappy.
Such a cute name.
The Drappy.
Sorry, I made fun of somebody's nut. I know.
Say that.
I was like, oh, your disgusting
you
sperm goes into the trash where it belongs.
Not like this.
I know. Even if I said that, it still comes off as sexual. I can't win.
Yeah, you have to be nice to the nut.
No, that's still sexual too. Chat, fuck off. I'm trying to have a conversation right now. Control yourselves. Tricky, am I having a deja vu, or did you have an old outfit before this one?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why I forgot. I feel like I can't.
You wanna go get it?
No, it's fine with the. I like how you look. I'm like, I don't know why, but I had a moment to myself. Was like, am I gaslighting myself?
Yeah, I had my original model, also done by the Ariku. I was a pirate.
Very beautiful.
Mm-hmm. You are it's okay. A pirate. Yay.
Yo, pirate's life is only for me. I don't remember.
For me.
I was thinking of fucking Bink Sake from One Piece, but I'm also somebody who spent too much time watching anime growing up instead of, you know, having a life.
I mean, I have this outfit too.
You look so cute. If I was a grandma, I'd pinch your cheeks. I'd be like, look at you. Look at you go.
No pinch.
Pinch
I'm a
the cheek.
Dragon.
Oh, look at you.
I'm a
Do you want some
dragon.
Food, honey? I'll make you a peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Fuck off.
I'll take off the crest for you.
No.
Must be a peanut butter and jelly, and I'll get you a salt and vinegar chip bag.
No. Booba's still here.
Do they want some of the chips?
Yeah.
I'll make them a sandwich, too.
He probably would.
That's all. So my cuteness aggression is either I like beat the shit out of you or I make you a little sandwich.
Oh, yes, please. Sandwich is nice.
Sandwich, please.
Please give me sandwich.
God, it's actually really cute. Fuck. I know it's just kind of you wearing a little. You look so cute.
Oh, thank you.
Why is this activating my empathy? It isn't a big dude like robe.
Yes, my cloak is the bag of tricky.
Are you?
Would you like a bag of tricky?
I would like a bag of tricky.
Yay.
Do you get like empathy triggers from when you see like certain emotes? Because for some reason I'm a weak bitch. When I see the fucking pleading eyes emote or like the one where they're smiling and crying, I get like empathy like just turned on, and I hate it. Like my fucking empathy turns on and I can't turn it off, and I feel weak. It's why I'm so nice to Numi all the time. She always looks like she's about to cry, and I'm just like, "Are you okay?"
Oh, no.
You're triggering my empathy.
Protect Numi at once.
I don't. When you do it, I'm just like, I want to feed you. I would feed tricky food.
Yeah, please. Give me food.
My weakness! God. No, giving me money isn't an empathy trigger. That's not how that works.
Empathy trigger. The chat strikes back.
That's not how that works.
The Giga Chad.
Well, I'm getting, you guys can't, Tempest, you can't do this to me. I just had somebody come into my stream like last month and they were like, here's half of my retirement fund. I can't react to this, don't. I can't. Ooh. They got a 10,000 again. Tricky has already eaten my leg. Are you okay? Do you eat meat?
Mm-mm.
Do you eat human? What the fuck? I thought you were vegan. I was gonna share my vegan marshmallows with you.
I mean, I would love some marshmallows. I do like marshmallows, but every
but they're
like,
vegan marshmallows.
But I'm sure I'm. Oh, thank the Chad.
The best. Holy fuck! Thank you for another 100 gifted subs! You have a big dick, a big heart, even bigger wallet! Thank you! Meet me after the stream, I'll put out. Thank you for the 100 bitties, thank you for the 100 subs! I'll meet you behind the Denny's. Holy fuck! Anyways, vegan marshmallows. What a fucking Chad, dude. I assume they're your regulars?
That's all I say, yes.
You're so cute. Stop activating my cuteness aggression. I'm gonna start throwing punches at you.
Oh yeah, punch me.
No!
Punch me.
Anyways, vegan marshmallows are just made with tapioca instead of like the animal fats. Mm-hmm. And it's much better. I like it more. It's like a chewier.
I would like to try it.
Tricky, we've already established you've eaten part, you know, sometimes you eat your chat as a part of like a sacrifice ritual, I assume.
Whoops.
Yeah, are you gonna deny it now? Somebody just told me that you ate their leg. They're half of them are half of them have prosthetic limbs, Tricky. You wanna explain yourself? Anyways. Would you, okay, so, I assume you like meat, right? How, can I finish a sentence? Can you move your head? He donated. What the fuck?
Oh, Tempest!
Thank you for another 100, Tempest!
Thank you, Tempest.
What the fuck? All right, you have a big dick, a big heart, even bigger wallet. Thank you!
Thank you.
Anyways, you can come back up now. You look too. I raise you up.
Is this good?
Yeah. Wait, a little to the left. You're like in front of me. Your little ears were like hitting my mouth. There we go. You have a good pout face. Anyways, what was I gonna ask? How do you? So, do you eat a lot of meat? Are you a big like meat person?
Yes.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. I've been getting more and more sick of meat. I feel like the only meat that I never get sick of is like jerky, and I don't know why.
Jerky is good. Oh yay, nut. No. Sorry.
Focus.
I'm sorry. I like well, steak is my favorite, which you do not like. Which
yeah,
we've
yeah,
already
we've discussed this. I'm not a steak person.
Yeah, we've already thought about this, so we can't get into this again.
Ignore it.
Okay.
It's gone. Real weak nut, chat. What is it? Only there for a second? Losers.
It's still nice and protein.
Stop! Stop!
I'm sorry. I don't mean to. I'm sorry.
This is the differences between our chats. Tricky is like, yo! And I'm like, you guys are disgusting.
Okay, anyway. So, I like steak, chicken. I love chicken. Chicken is like...
I do like chicken a lot. I think chicken is banging. That one, you know, the dick sound effect sounds like me. Ariel, thank you for the 4 months.
Yeah. You showed me your own version of your dick.
Dicks! Wait, what?
You know what I... You know, like, you're...
I have not shown anything to anyone, thank
you. You know what I mean? Like, your thing.
I know, but I have to preface this for anyone that clips this. I have not shown anything to anyone. If you're a clipper and you're looking for a fucking a goddamn clip, fuck you, fuck off, eat shit. There's nothing there. It's all in the closet and you'll never be able to see it. Unless you're a fucking rich 1% of the capitalistic world, you're not getting under my skirt. Eat shit. This cock is mine alone. And your mother, if she's very happy with it.
Oh. you know what I mean.
I know what you mean. I know when you flub up your words. I always just preface it.
Okay. Very good.
Teehee. Yeah, I think chicken is... you know what? If I had to choose between chicken and beef, I'd say chicken is better. Chicken's more versatile. Mm. Plus fried chicken. You don't fry fucking beef.
Oh, fried chicken is probably my favorite chicken. Second is barbecue chicken.
Or Kentucky fried? If you had to choose fried chicken. I mean, there's also homemade, but if you had to choose between Kentucky and Korean.
Korean.
I don't like
Kentucky chicken that much.
Because it's terrible. Kentucky, fuck you. I hate Kentucky fried chicken. I hate KFC. Like,
Popeye's chicken is superior in every way.
You know, I've never had Popeye's yet.
Oh, you need to get some Popeyes.
I don't have any food for tomorrow, so I might as well order some.
Yeah.
Every time I go to I look at DoorDash Popeyes, I'm just like, I mean, I'm gonna buy. What if the one chicken sandwich doesn't fill me up? What am I gonna eat? Myself? What?
Raising Cane's though. Have you ever had Raising Cane's?
I haven't, but everyone tells me that Raising Cane's is fucking amazing.
It's amazing. You have to get the extra sauce, like extra sauce with the fucking bread.
Ugh. Thank you for the $25, Tempest. I appreciate it. No, I moved you. It's fine. I can just move you. You don't have to move yourself.
Okay.
I don't do all the work, honey. You're doing wonderful. You live your life. You be happy.
Okay.
But I hear a lot of good things about Raising Cane's. I used to watch the, I forgot his name. The Review Bra. I used to watch Review Bra all the time, and I fucking I love that man.
I don't think I've ever seen him.
It's the spindly looking dude who has like the who always wears the suit and slick backed hair.
Oh,
he's the one who's like my day is ruined and my disappointment is immeasurable.
That reminds me of something that I used to see. It was like Anonymous Cook or something, or Anonymous. I don't remember. It was just like. The Shadow Man.
What?
It was like a Shadow Man, and he would like review video games and food.
You know what my favorite TikTok channel is?
When is it?
I would love for you to see this next time you do a TikTok react. It's it's this account that's just called Hummus Man,
and Hummus Man.
All he does is it's just this Scottish guy, and he's just like Kit Kat. Does it go with hummus? And then he dips it in the hummus, eats it, and he's like either like Yes. No. And that's his entire account. Every day he has a new video of him dipping something in hummus, and it's amazing. Ferrero Rocher. He does it go fun. With hummus? Yes.
No.
It's so good.
I love accents.
My balls.
So much.
Does it? Oh, yeah. No, I love accents.
Would you put your balls in hummus?
You know, they say that you can taste with your balls. I haven't tried it, because I'm dead and I have no taste buds as a dead doll. But back when I was alive, I should have tried it. I don't know if anyone else in the chat has tried it. Men in the chat.
What?
You ever taste?
What?
I'm pretty sure it's a fucking internet myth that went around where they were saying men can taste things with their balls and they were just doing it to fuck with people.
Are you just gonna get a plate?
No!
Put your testicles. Don't do that.
Can women taste with their titties?
With what?
Can women taste with titty if men can taste with balls?
Well, no. I've never been able to taste with my titties.
Yeah, but we should lie. We should spread misinformation on the internet about it.
Oh, I was literally touch. Oh, okay, never mind. Yes, I could totally taste.
I can. I can taste.
The nipples just absorb the flavor.
Oh, God. Fucking hell. Oh, my God. Thank you for the biddies, guys. That's so stupid.
Oh, delicious.
Oh, no. It's so stupid. No.
Come here. Put your face right there on
no!
your
face. No! No!
Come.
I gotta go. Oh my God.
I really need to taste it.
Yeah, thank you for the biddies. Two favorite streamers. I'm glad you like us. You know, I relate to that barbecue sauce in my titties meme, like on a spiritual level. Sometimes I wake up, you know, I'm an exerciser. I like to exercise. Tricky, I've been on Tricky stream while exercising before. I like exercise.
Apex?
Yeah, yeah. I exercise in the middle of the night for like 6 hours. It's not like intense, chat. Before anyone's like, oh, he's a giga chad. I just like get on the treadmill, or not the treadmill, the exercise bike or my rowing machine, and I just like exercise for a couple hours. Real chill, casual, like, but sometimes because I exercise and I take care of myself, I like watch what I eat. Sometimes in the middle of the night, maybe I'll be up at 5 a.m. I just get out of bed all fours on the ground. I crawl around like a fucking creature of the night and I fucking open the. Do you mind?
Sorry.
Do you mind?
Okay, go on.
Anyways, like I was saying, I walk around on all fours in the middle of the night like the La Creatura, and I fucking crawl over to the fridge, and I don't open the fridge. On the basket on top of the fridge, chat, I grab a big family-sized bag of Lay's barbecue potato chips with my mouth, and I fucking go... And I fucking tear it open and I eat it on the floor like a fucking freak. I eat the entire bag. I leave nothing. I'm like naked in the middle of the night eating a bag of chips on the ground. And I wake up in the morning and there's just barbecue chip crumbs on my titties or on my pectoral muscles because I'm a man.
Yeah, let's go.
And I'm just angry. And I wake up and I'm like in a drunken stupor like, what happened?
Wow. What?
I don't know if anyone else does that sometimes, but I do it a lot.
Does this happen often for you?
Yeah, I get it. I turn into a malicious hungry animal, maybe once a month.
What did you drink?
Nothing. I just turned into a fucking freak.
Oh, you just
freak.
Turned into.
I just get hungry in the middle of the night and I turn feral.
Yeah, yeah. I've broken a bed before. I saw that.
Wait, for food, right? You did that. You broke the bed when hungry, right?
Yep, you can say that.
Right?
Yep. I was definitely hungry.
She's so wholesome.
I am wholesome.
Yeah.
I love people that are very open and respectful about their sexual life. I think it's really cool. I have a lot of friends. I think you are too. I have a friend named Lily Bell who showed me that it's like really healthy to be open with yourself and like that. And I was like, wow, you guys are so based.
I used to be very private about it, but then like the older I get, the less fucks I give, I suppose.
Yeah, which is a good thing, I would say.
Yeah, I just like, it feels better to just be open.
I think if you can talk about it in a healthy and open way, it's good for you and your mental state. I'm not ready for it yet. I'm not.
Yeah, yeah, take your time. Take your time.
My porcelain is still, my genitalia is locked in the closet and it's not coming out until I'm ready. I ain't taking that out. I only wear the uselessly large one just to fucking put out the big dick energy when I'm streaming.
Whenever you are comfortable and happy with it, that's the best time to be open with yourself. Because whenever you feel like you have, or like if you're obligated to share, like overshare, like that's not cool.
Don't do that. Coming out of the closet. I don't know. I lean a little. What's the word? I'm not asexual, but I lean towards that, where I like my work more. I don't have a need. Yeah, yeah.
I'm Demi. And a lot of people are like, oh, wait. Trust me, I find a lot of people attractive. And
we should have a spreadsheet for these.
Yeah, like I...
Is there a gay spreadsheet or a sexuality spreadsheet?
The thing about it, whenever I just... whenever I described it before, like, oh, I have to have an emotional connection with someone before I get, like, horny for them.
Yeah.
And then they're like, isn't that, like, a normal relationship? I'm like, I feel like the majority of people just look at something and, like, okay,
because people can still get horny over, like, you know, like, hentai or, like, just, like, a celebrity.
But, like, that doesn't happen for me.
Yeah.
I can watch stuff and I could be like, eh.
Gray sexual? Is that what I am?
Perhaps.
I'm looking it up. I'm opening up the gay spreadsheet.
Because I'm Demi. I'm demisexual, so. There's like a big old list of all of them. I just also have a very like... I like dirty jerks, so like...
They're funny! I like saying cock and then having people laugh.
Yeah, I do too. Like, I'm the same way.
Do you want to do a test for humor?
Yeah,
I call it the Zoomer humor test. So I'm going to say something, and if you laugh, generally you'd be put under Zoomer humor. Okay? Because most people that don't have this type of humor would never laugh at this because they think it's stupid.
But I've already had the giggles. I laugh at random words. You said like one thing, and I was like, huh.
I know.
Plate.
So I know you probably, that's why you're, I think you might fail this, but it's still, it's fun to do. All right, already? I want you to look at me. Cock. Balls. Cum. Cock. Balls. Nuts.
Nope, didn't laugh.
Cock! Okay.
Why did you say it like that?
That was the last one. That was the last one.
You didn't have to say it like that.
Well, I put the reverb on because I thought it would hit you harder.
You didn't have to do it like that. Hey, cack!
Cack.
That's not Zoomer humor. Cack. That's been funny.
No. It's Zoomer humor because it has an echo and it's just the word. That's it. Cack!
Yeah, it's funny. It's pretty funny. But I don't know. It's funny. I don't know.
Well, I like cock, but not in like... It has to be used in a certain like a context for the subject. I can't just laugh at the one joke. I'm bisexual. I can say it. I'm pansexual, bisexual. I got it.
I like both. Nice
cock. I think that's great.
I like both.
Yo, thank you. I polish it every night before bed.
Nice cock.
Yeah, thank you. I polish it. I use WD-40 and porcelain polish.
Porcelain polish.
Make sure it's nice and shiny. What the fuck is that laugh?
I don't know.
I don't know. I have the giggles.
So goofy.
I have the giggles.
No, it's perfect for when we're doing streams because now everything that I clip is going to sound funny because somebody's laughing in it.
That's cheating.
Do you have that? When you hear somebody laugh, do you just start laughing even if it's not funny?
Yeah.
It's so good.
It just makes me happy.
It just makes everything funnier.
Yeah. It just gives me serotonin, honestly.
Thanks for the 1,000 biddies, but I don't get scared that easily.
It's a good thing I can't hear.
Yeah, I don't get scared at... I can make it so you can hear it. Do you want to hear them?
No.
Here, I can put it on my mic. I can make it come out of my mic.
No.
Here, there we go. Now it'll come out of my mic.
Oh, good.
It'll be great.
Oh, no.
It'll be great. You'll love it. Hold on. It's going to be fantastic. I don't wait, no, you're hearing the music now. Sorry. There we go. Did you hear that?
Yep, yes, I did. I don't like that.
Hi, Milky. So you play a lot of horror games, and I try to play a lot of horror games, too. How would you say your scare meter is? Because I feel like I'm at, like, a 1. Like, I rarely ever get scared unless it's something completely out of nowhere. Like, I got more scared in Elden Ring than in horror games. Yeah, Faith was not scary, chat. That was funny to me.
A gun with one bullet.
The thing with spookies for me, I'm very jumpy, so boom. Whenever, well, not like that.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Sorry.
If I play grounded, I will die. I am definitely arachnophobic.
Oh, are you scared of spiders?
Yeah, and every time I play anything with that, I die.
Is it like really, really bad?
I can show you a grounded has very fast.
Grounded has the arachnophobia filter.
Yeah, but I don't. The reason why we even play it to begin with, we hit a goal for me to even play. So I know of the arachnophobia mode, and usually we only play it whenever. Like,
can you stop making noises for 1 minute?
It's a bop.
No, no, sorry. What were you saying?
Eh?
Oh, fuck you, chat! Anyways, have you ever... So I used to be... I don't know if you know this. I used to be scared of dolls. And now I am one.
Oh.
And I did something called Fuck Your Fears. And basically what I did...
something similar to that.
Well, yeah. Basically what I did was I drew myself... Or I drew a really hot doll. And because the doll was so hot, I didn't get scared of dolls anymore. Now I'm attracted to them. Same thing worked with me with the ghosts. Like, ever since I saw Sadako from the Japanese version of The Ring, not the American version where she's a child, I'm talking about when she's a MILF, I always have to fucking clarify that. I have been so attracted to ghosts now that if I'm in my house in the middle of the night and I feel like there's a ghost there, I just fucking take my pants off and I'm like, let's go. I'm fucking ready, baby. Come on out. Where are you? I'm ready.
Just take your pants
off. I'm rock hard and I'm ready to party hard.
I can't speak. I have something similar to that with spiders, yeah.
So spider girls, are you okay with, but you can't deal with, like, you still can't deal with spiders yet?
I can't do, like, if, I can do jumping spiders because
they're
fuzzy.
Cute. Yeah, they're little babies.
But, like, wolf spiders and, like, huntsman spiders.
Even though you know they're, like, not, they're dangerous at all. It's just,
they're
like...
They're so scary. I don't know what... Okay, let me show you this random clip. This is not grounded, but I was reacting to a random meme clip, and there was just a random spider that came out of nowhere.
Okay.
And I died.
Was it that bad?
Ooh, penis, huh? Yeah. Just...
Stop distracting her!
Sorry. Okay, let me get it.
It's okay. It's chat's fault if anything goes wrong. But, like, I also have a very bad fear, and it's of the deep ocean. So I have thalassophobia.
Oh, thalassophobia. Yeah, I have that mildly.
I have it really bad. Like, I can't, if I play a video game and I see an abyss under me, I get like a pit in my stomach and I freak out.
Oh no.
But I still do games with it because I'm an asshole. But even though I'm terrified of it. Yeah, yeah. Even though I'm terrified of it, I still find Eldritch Horror and like deep sea stuff the coolest shit in the world. Like, even though I have horror with it, it's so fucking cool. Like, any story that is a plotline revolving around the deep fucking dark ocean is so cool to me.
Yeah, because I'm the same way with, let's see, underwater? Like, underwater...
Thank you, Tempest! Yeah, feel free to send it. Yeah, underwater.
Underwater animatronics. I'm terrified of those.
Animatronics? That's specific.
Yeah, I think it's just because...
Soma, right?
Have you ever been on, like... I actually never played Soma before.
Submechaphobia.
Yeah, that's the one. Submechaphobia.
That's such an oddly specific thing.
Yeah, it's very weird because thinking about them being in the water with me is like the worst thing ever. Because have you ever seen like Anaconda or like Placid and stuff like
that?
Well,
I haven't seen the movie, but I know what you're talking about with Anaconda.
Yeah, yeah. So that's a whole animatronic. Yeah, and of course they put a little bit of CGI on it to make it more, you know. But the main... like, I'm not scared of snakes at all. I love snakes. But the idea of a fake snake with, like, all of the machinery and getting, like, wrapped up in it or stepping on it or something, I don't know. It freaks me out. And then, like, Bruce from Jaws, like, the animatronic from Jaws.
Yeah.
I don't, like, thinking about being in the water with he. I would die.
Let me see. I have this clip up, but let me see if I can grab a Lassophobia screenshot to show you what I mean. So, let's say you're in the middle of the ocean. There's nothing around you, and you just look down, and it's an abyss. That terrifies me. That idea is the scariest thing in the world to me. And I'm looking at images right now. Hold on. I'm looking at images right now, and it's even then, I'm freaking out. All right. So let me move to the, I'm going to move to the right if you want to come with me to the right side.
Oh, okay.
So wait, let's go.
So if
right,
flipped,
left for you.
So I go this way.
Yeah.
Okay. All the way?
Oh, fuck.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? Maybe just go on the left side.
I'm already gone.
You disappeared into another dimension.
Yeah, you have a door here, by the way.
What do you mean I have a door here?
You have a door here.
Do you have a third dimension that I don't know about?
Yeah, there's a door here.
What the fuck kind of Yu-Gi-Oh! Yeah, bullshit is this?
There's a door here. You didn't know
that. What is that? The fucking Harry Potter convenience robe that turns you into invisible?
Yeah, it happens sometimes.
Alright, go to the left then. Okay, wait, now too far.
Oh.
Still on the screen, just make yourself smaller. Okay, right? Right? A little bit more. A little bit more. All right, stop. Go down. A little bit more. A little bit more to the right now. Perfect. All right, good. She takes directions way better than you guys do.
I'm flipped. My brain is like, oh wait, everything's backwards.
No, you did good.
Yay.
All right, so I have your arachnophobia clip up.
Oh yeah,
let's see it.
Yikes.
All right, pause my music.
You see what they did to me?
Wait, hold on, I have to turn the music off. Oh my god. Wait, hold on. Oh, the spiders and the other thing. Wow. That's so perfect, the way the clip ended too. You fucking disappeared immediately.
Oh, I died.
Holy shit, that was so funny.
I died. I don't like.
So I don't get that immediate scare. I get like a pit of like fear. So like, if you look at the screen chat, I'll show you some ideas of the Lassophobia.
That shark thing.
I think that's a dead shark.
No. That's a statue.
Oh, okay. Don't look.
Dude, okay. I saw the video of that. We watched it on stream. It's the statue. It's on the very bottom of a lake.
and it's like I felt like I would actually have a heart attack and die. So the lake is like super duper murky, murky water is like. Ooh.
Sorry, ooh, Sorry, I got a pit in my stomach from this image.
Oh.
This hole is
chat, I'm suffering, so you understand. This is like the epitome of thalassophobia. Yeah. Like, there's nothing in the water, but the landmass and the way, like, the water looks is making me have a pit in my stomach, and it freaks me out.
Oh. I'm mostly scared of the things that are in the water.
That's a part of it. Like, that's a part of it, but the abyss by itself makes me fucking freak out.
Yeah, that's understandable. I just need to be able to see, because I love water. I love to swim.
I like swimming, too. It's...
But if I can't see where I'm going, I freak out.
Fuck. Oh, my God. Okay, I'm going to take this off the screen now. Oh, my God. Oh, okay. It feels like my stomach's turning inside out. You can come back on the screen.
Damn.
Oh, my God. Anyways, even though I have the thalassophobia, if I were to read, like, a manga or, like, a webtoon about the deep ocean... And, like, how there's, like, eldritch entities or just creepy stuff. Or just even the abyss by itself. Like, there's nothingness. Like, there's nothing in there besides the water. I would still think that's really fucking cool while also being terrified of it. It's so weird that I can be so in love with something that I'm terrified of.
Mm-hmm. I'm the same way with, like, just underwater stuff. I cannot do that with spiders, though. I die. Well, the only other... Well, I needed spider inspiration for another character.
Yeah.
So, like, I subscribed to Exotic Lair, which is a person who, like, feeds spiders and has a whole bunch of, like, tarantula videos.
I've seen some of those.
Tarantulas don't bother me as much anymore. It's usually, like, the really, really skinny-looking ones, the big skinny ones that freak me out the most.
Really?
But, like, I have to psych myself up before I click on a video, if that makes any sense. So, like, if somebody just randomly sent me a tarantula, I'll die. But, like, if I... prepare myself to watch it, then I won't die as much, I guess.
I get how you feel. I used to have a fear of spiders. If I see like a tiny spider on my desk, I still freak out because I don't have knowledge about them. My thing with spiders, if I don't know what it is, I'm not fucking with it. Or it's gonna die. If I know it's not gonna hurt me, I still sometimes am kinda like you're like if I see a spider in the bathroom, I'm like, what if you crawled up on me while I'm taking a shit?
Nope.
Sorry. Didn't mean to fuck with you like that.
Oh, the legs.
I like. Otherwise, I'm not. It's not really a fear. I'm just like, you, grody. Get off. Don't come near me. Like, if you want to stay in the corner of the room, I'm not gonna bother trying to kill you. But if you come near me, you're dead.
I got bitten by a brown recluse on my leg, and I got like a big bite on my knee.
Wait, a brown recluse? Do I need to look that up? How bad are they?
They're venomous.
I won't show it on stream, but...
Please do
not. Yeah, that's not a pretty spider. That's not a cutie.
I felt it crawl up my leg, so I always have that sensation. Like, every time I see a spider, I feel the spider go up my leg.
Yes! Okay, I had a clip before when I was... Because I was... Back when people were watching those Rich People House videos, I was watching one, and... Ooh. A spider was on my desk, and I spent 20 minutes trying to kill it. It was a cute spider. It was like a small little guy. He wasn't freaky or anything, but because he got away for the rest of the stream, I kept like imagining something crawling on my leg, and it made me freak out.
That's the worst part.
I hate it.
And then
I'm like, no, that's where my crotch is. Get away.
There's also cockroaches. I am terrified of cockroaches because I've also had like several of them crawl up my leg whenever I've been on the computer.
Can I tell you a horror story, or is this going to be too much for you to handle? About cockroaches, not spiders.
I can do this. Yeah. Okay, tell the story.
When I was a kid, so my mom and dad are divorced, but I went to, and my dad was on a vacation in his homeland of some sort. And I went to visit him, and in the house... I got up at 3 a.m. to get some water and maybe make myself like a little peanut butter and jelly sandwich. And I didn't turn any of the lights because I didn't want to wake anyone up. So I was walking around in the dark. And as I got the sandwich out of the fridge, I got my drink of some lemonade or some water or whatever. And I close the fridge and I feel something on my neck, like on my collarbone. And I look down and there's a cockroach on my collarbone. And I fucking immediately drop all the food, slam the cockroach, and I go, and I shit you not, this is the noise I made. And I ran like a little fucking fruitcake to my bed, and I went back to bed. That's exactly the noise I made. I made sound like one of the fear. Fucking thumbs from from fucking Spy Kids 3.
Spy Kids.
One of the floobles.
The floobles. Dude, I used to listen to the song from Spy Kids 1 all the time.
No, like,
it's a cool world. And, that's kind of a bop.
Spy Kids, I rewatched Spy Kids with my chat back when I did movie nights a lot more, and it was so fucking funny.
I want to bang the dad.
Yeah, he's hot.
I love me some Antonio
Banderas. Antonio Banderas.
Ah, yummy.
He is hot. Is he
love Zorro.
Is he the voice of Puss in Boots? He is, yeah. Right? Yeah, he's sexy. He's the reason why the fucking I've been obsessed with Latin accents lately.
Mm-hmm. It is a very, 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 very sexy accent.
It's actually moved up in my top two. Like, my top 10 of accents are... my number one is German. My number two was French. My number three is a Chinese accent. Four is probably Spanish. Five is Scottish. And then six is Australian. And then the last three change all the time. Tempest! Thank you for another... thank you for more money. I didn't see what it was in time, but thank you!
Sorry.
No, don't be sorry. I like looking at you. You're my guest. No, I like it when you're in the stream. I enjoy you.
Well, thank you.
Thank you, Tempest, though. You have a big dick, a big heart, a bigger wallet. It was the clip link. Just post it in the chat, man. You don't even have to get money for that. I got to open up Stream Elements for that. I'm not like other streamers. I don't have Stream Elements open for links and donations. Teehee. And you appreciate it. Anyways, Spy Kids is really good. Those are my top seven accents. German accents are really sexy because I like how they sound. Italian accents are good too. I've recently started getting really into Chinese accents because I think they're really nice.
Every accent just
You know what? All fucking accents are really hot. There's no accent that I don't like except for maybe Kay Kona. But even then, sometimes the Southern Belle accent is nice. It's just like Southern.
You would like Nouvelle then.
Nouvelle?
That's the spider they keep talking about.
Is it a Spider Girl VTuber?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really? Yeah. I haven't met him.
Okay, one second.
Wait, is it you? Are you? Is that you? Is this some kind of old personality thing?
Well, we have to have therapy somehow.
Oh! I knew it. I did see that. I did see that character. I went to your stream once and I didn't say anything, but I saw it and I was like, that's so nice looking. What the fuck?
I can... One moment.
It just leaves. What is this clip? Oh. Ooh, I don't like that sound. I see you guys giving tricky. I'm watching one of the clips that Tempest sent. I see you getting a lot of money, and then somebody sent the sound effect of like a little spider crawling around.
No, I'm not clicking that.
Chat, spiders don't make noises. That's not a real thing.
But even if they could be.
They don't have. They can't make noise.
But they could.
What do you mean they could?
It's the legs. It'd be like.
What do you think the spider's gonna be like? Hey!
I wish they'll be a lot less scary.
Do you think it would help you if you imagine spiders talking like the fucking Lego City announcer?
Yeah.
Hey! A man has fallen in Lego City's river.
What's up?
Okay, use your spider string to reach out to them.
This PNG might be big, so I'm so sorry in advance.
It's okay. Show me your big, strong PNG, Tricky. Some spiders can hiss.
Some spiders can hiss.
I read that as piss.
Wait,
nothing.
What?
Do you think you would be less scared if spiders knew how to piss?
We gotta funny.
What if you just see you? Wait, imagine there's a spider in your room and you just like walk up to it and it just starts pissing itself in fear. Like it's not moving and you just see it. It's like pissing itself because it's terrified. It's like the peepo piss emote.
It would still have the legs.
Yeah, but it's pissing. It's like scared of you. It's just like a puddle is appearing under it.
I wish they were like, no, please.
No, please, don't kill me.
If they sounded cute, then, you know, I'll be like, oh, okay, I'm sorry. I was being judgmental.
You just reminded me how cute, there are some really fucking cute spiders out there, like the orb weavers.
No!
No, the female ones. The female ones are really cute.
They're long.
Am I thinking of the wrong spider?
Google orb weaver.
Is this the wrong spider?
They are long and scary.
Orb weaver. Oh, there it is. It's this little guy who looks like a fruit. Gastrocantha cancriformis. A spiny-backed spider. It's called a spiny-backed spider. A spiny-backed orb weaver. They just look like a Pokemon. Wait, can you handle Spinarak from Pokemon?
Yes, because he doesn't have 8 legs.
Oh, fuck, he doesn't. I like Ariados, too.
I don't like him. He also doesn't have 8 legs, but he's more scary.
For context, I gifted her 300 subs, then did the spider noise and scared the shit out of her. I'm so sorry about your chat, Tricky. My chat would never.
Yeah, that was rude.
Yeah, set them.
That was rude.
My chat's... I feel like I have, like, the masochistic chat out of most VTubers. Everyone else's chat is, like, bullying the streamer, and then my chat's like... shake the cage. Or don't shake the cage, but spit on me.
Oh, damn. Like, I have a mixture of, like, trolls, because I'm also a troll.
Yeah.
Like, we love to troll people.
Yeah.
But then they troll me, and then I die. And then banter begins, because, you know, banter with chat is probably the most fun. I love banter with chat. And then I eat their legs, and then all the other fun stuff. And then, let's see, what else?
What the fuck is that?
Sometimes horny.
Yes. Well, most of my chat's a lot of the times horny sometimes. But I it's always like, I hate you, chat. Stop talking to me. You disgust me. Question for you both. What would you do if Ariados is crawling on you? I would give him a little pat on his belly. I'd be like, who's a good boy? You're a good boy. I like Ariados a lot. I always thought they were really cute. Thank you for the 60. Big love, Tempest. And Fox Fennel. Thank you for the raid. Big love. Hope you're having a nice night. Thank you for coming by. Welcome to the Stream Raiders. My name is Porcelain Maid. I used to be a sexy second man before I died, and my soul got trapped inside the body of a sexier female doll. He and pronouns, though, because if you're still confused about pronouns in the 21st century, you can think of me as a bisexual's wet dream. Do you have the PNG, Tricky? I'm on a date with Tricky Wee Raiders. Welcome.
It's very large, so I'm trying to figure out how to make it small, but I can't.
Do you want to just put it, like, send it to me?
I could also do that.
And then I can just show it on stream.
That's true.
Yeah. You don't have to it up in your own VTube studio.
Oh, no. Well, like, I was just going to get it. It's just going to be huge.
Do you not have a screenshot of them or, like, anything smaller? Hi, Ushi.
A bit. I usually do. What did I do with that?
I like that Tricky can blep. Chad, do you know that I actually had a blep function, but we never rigged it? I was able to stick my tongue out, but they took my tongue from me.
Get a blep. Get a bleep.
I should get a blep.
I love blep.
And what's that? You're asking if my tongue is made out of porcelain or not? Why don't you come find out then, bitch?
Oh, this works. I gotta use this.
That's a new tweet. I'm putting that in my tweet drafts. Stop asking if my tongue is made out of porcelain or not and just come find out, coward. That's gonna go in the tweet drafts. Would you ever 10 million spiders crawl on you or be tossed in the dark abyss of the ocean? Tempest, I'm going to take your money and I'm going to ignore you. Thanks for the $25. Fucking. Oh, they're so pretty. Who drew this one? This one looks like Kamo's art.
It is.
It is Kamo! Yo! Kamo, if you ever see this clip, I just want you to know I'm so fucking based. I love you. You're so hot. Do you want to make out, MILF? MILF Kamo? MILF Kamo?
Very talented.
Anyways, I love this. This is gorgeous.
Yeah, thank you.
Look at it. Look at it.
All right. Oh, is it, wait, is this like a change of roleplay now?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is new Vaya.
Can you show the full body? Or did you cut it off?
I cut it off so it won't be so big.
It's okay. I'm okay with big women.
Big women?
I like big women.
Oh, I bet you do, honey. Yeah, that nervous little leg.
Oh my god. Dude, the Southern Belle accents are super. They hit sometimes, but sometimes it's like. You gotta be like, it's gotta be CERN Southern Belle. Cause if it's like modern day Southern Belle, it's a miss. But if it's like olden, like, what's up, honey? Like that, it's like, okay, I get what you're saying. I like what you're putting down on the table.
What was that, your Southern? Yeah. Is that what you think we sound like?
That was my idea of Southern Belle. Uh-huh. Oh, now who's donating? Thank you for the $10! Thanks. I'm just going to assume every sub or donation is Tempest. No, come back Tempest, up. Stop moving for the subs, right? Tricky, you're more important to them because you're my guest. Money will not put anyone above you, all right? You're the guest here.
Yeah. Well, thank you, honey.
How do you pronounce Nouvelle? Or like, is it
Nouvelle?
Nouvelle.
Nouvelle.
Nouvelle. Can you show the full body?
I can. I just need to get another PNG very fast.
Is this PNG not? Is this cut off?
Yeah, it's cut off.
It's okay. It's fine. I'll just come by to your streams when you show them off again.
Yeah, I can do that.
That's so pretty.
Just for you.
Can you call Tricky back, please?
Yes, I can.
Oh my god, thank you.
Bye now.
I'll meet you later.
Yeah.
Tricky! Thank you. Sorry, while you were gone, I went on a date, and me and Nouvelle were like, hey, do you want to make out? And then we made out in front of everyone. You missed it.
Why not me? Why not sandwich?
Like, it was tongue-on-tongue action. I was tongue-punching her in the throat.
Why not sandwich?
I don't know, Tricky. It's just, you know, I mean, it's, we're on a date, but, you know.
But you
yeah, it's our first date, Tricky. Come on. We need at least a little bit more than that. Can't do that on the first time, right? What am I gonna make out with somebody as soon as I meet them?
Yeah.
Yeah, immediately makes out with Nouvelle.
What the fuck? You wouldn't immediately make out with me, but you'll do Nouvelle? What the fuck?
Every time I go to your stream, the first message I say is moi.
Oh yeah, that's true.
That's like my highs.
Hiya.
Tricky was just under Nouvelle's dress the entire time.
Yeah, that's where I'm always. I'm always underneath the dress. Just like, taste a spider.
Do you think that you look cuter because we can't see your arms in this? So it's just like, look at her. She's just a little guy.
I'm just a little. I'm just a little. I'm just like.
Chad, do you think the loss of arms kind of makes her look very, like, really, like, oh my god, oh, yeah.
Maybe.
I think it is. It makes you kind of look like a little, fuck, what's the word?
Maybe it's the hood?
It could be the hood. A peepee coat? Oh god, wait. It does kind of look like a penis now, fuck. That's gonna bother me a lot. Oh, why'd you say that?
No!
It's in my head now!
Well, yeah, it's pretty funny.
It was so cute before. Oh my god. No!
Pee pee.
No, shut the. Not the sax.
Pee pee.
Not the sax!
Pee pee coat.
A petticoat, but it's a peepee coat or a sperm coat.
Peepee coat. There you go. Is that better?
Yeah, I feel better now. Less clothes actually makes me more comfortable here.
Oh, very good.
Who would have thought? Oh boy, the tables have turned.
Well, we do also have a naked model.
Oh, really?
No, I'm not, but.
I have a base model. We don't have, there's no like genitalia or anything on it, but I use it for like ball joint reference. Yeah, I think most VTubers should have that, right? For like outfits and stuff.
Mm-hmm. It should be a lot easier for new outfits.
We recently did an outfit poll. There's one still going on right now where we had 7 new outfits that people could vote for, and whichever one won was our next new outfit.
Can I say what I voted for?
Yeah, you can say what you voted for.
I voted for pirate every single time.
Dude, pirate was winning in the first poll, and now it's losing to sundress right now.
The sundress is still very, very cute.
I'm so mad because the two ones that were doing the worst were Gym Rat and the Knight. And I was like, why? Gym Rat and the Knight. Fuck! Gym Rat and the Knight were really good. Where is the poll? I don't have it on me, but if you look at my Twitter link or Twitter media, it's up there. You can vote for them there. It's going to be up for a while.
Yes.
Do you have an outfit that you really want in the future to get? Yeah.
One's in progress.
Okay, besides that one, do you have one that you really want to get?
I want to get a Mechasys outfit. It's Robo Tricky.
Fuck, that's actually really cool.
Yeah, I want to do that because I have like another thingy that I do.
Yeah.
And I can't do the voice effect now because obviously, you know, I don't have my thingy right now.
Yeah, feel that. Robot outfits are really cool. I want a mushroom outfit.
Oh, mushroom sounds wonderful.
Like mushrooms growing on me. Ooh. Like I'm some kind of like freak that is like a disease where the mushrooms are growing on my face.
You must.
That was one of the outfits, but I want a different one from that. I want it more mushy and gross.
More mushy.
I want it to look terrifying, if I'm being completely honest.
Do you want like another like hairstyle along with it? And
so we have three hairstyles right now, right? So I have bob cut, which is what I'm wearing right now. We have the original hairstyle. Shut up! We have the ponytail, we have the bob cut, and then we have the original. We're getting a pigtails by the end of the month. So that's also a thing. And then I have my nun outfit one. Oh my god. You look so cute! Look at you! How many do you have?
I only have
short hair.
I have long hair.
Long hair.
I have
pigtails.
Longer bangs, pigtails, and then hair erection.
Hair erection. Oh, the pigtails turn into twin tails.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so cute. Look at our hair. Yeah. Do short hair with me.
Okay. Ah, blah, blah. Oh, wrong button.
Wrong button again.
What?
Still wrong button. There you go.
Okay, there we go.
Look at us. Pose with me. If you ever get a Kudo board, I'm using this and putting it on the Kudo board, and then you'll be like, oh my god, I remember that. That's so happy times.
Yeah, the happy times. The happy times.
Chad, take a screenshot.
Oh, sorry.
Wait, lean.
Like that?
Yeah, that works.
Yay!
It's cute. I love that. Whoops. Anyways, besides all that, can we? No. Tricky. Don't get close to them. They're savage. Why do you think chat's in a cage? No! I gotta say, you're one of the best VTubers in terms of being able to like use everything on command. Using everything your model has to offer. It's always super cool to watch your stream. Because I try my best to use everything. Even my raid intro has all my toggles and everything on it. Sometimes it's a little hard for me to like do everything, you know. I use my angry face. I never smile. Because it feels weird. I never smile.
I don't smile.
I never cry as much because I'm always just angry. My one emotion is anger. But I feel like you use everything that you have, and it's really always impressive compared to other VTubers. Because some people don't even use any of their toggles. They just pay for them.
I have a lot of emotions.
And I'm just impressed that you just have like you have the shortcuts at the ready to put them on at all times. You're so fast with that shit.
Yeah.
All right, let me do a height comparison. I want to see how tall you are with me. Zoom out.
Wow.
Wait, you're flying. That's cheating.
You dying.
Do you mind?
Sorry.
You're bending. Oh, don't fly over here. Okay. Can you cut, like, fly down a little bit?
Okay, fine. I'll do this.
Oh, that works too. Alright. Why are you so small? Okay, that's not what I meant. Wait, go. I need to see your full body on the screen so we can compare our heights.
I'm working on it.
Okay, just stop. Stop right there. Don't move. I'll do all the moving from now on. Okay. Chat, does this look like we're the same head size? Maybe a little bit smaller. Is this good, chat? Do you think we're the same size here and I can do it? Okay. Then. Oh, God. Tricky. How tall are you canonically?
5'5".
Oh, this is so cute.
What?
Look at the screen. Look at the screen.
Oh, I'm in the plastic.
Ignore them. Ignore them. Look at you. Oh, wait, hold on. I have to match your feet. There we go. Look at her. You're at pectoral height.
Hey, fuck off. I'm huge. I'm huge. I'm a big ferocious dragon.
The doll, obviously. the doll, 6'1", back when I was alive, 6'2". I think this kind of matches. Your horns give you, do you count your horns in your height? Or?
No.
Okay, so you're five,
with my head.
And then with horns, you'd be like 5'7".
Yeah.
I think this matches up, right? This is basically it, right?
Yeah.
This is so cute. Look at this.
I'm waiting until I get my, well, I need to get off of probation. Then I'll be able to turn into big dragon again.
Maybe if you stopped fucking around and causing fires to spread in people's mansions, you wouldn't be on probation for so long. You ever think about that?
I don't mean to.
You gotta control yourself.
I don't mean to. It's just so funny.
You almost burned down my poor chat.
I didn't mean it.
Do you see how they were freaking out at the beginning?
Oh, damn. Oh, that's a big head you got there.
You got a big head.
That's a big head you got there.
Yeah, what you... Oh, boy. This is horrific.
Oh, yes, it's wonderful.
I'm crawling over to you.
Oh, crawl. Crawling, crawling.
Hey, you can get bigger now.
Oh, I can? Okay.
Yeah. Dicks! Oh, God. Oh, God!
Dicks!
Oh, God!
Hello.
Wait, I can't see. You're covering me. Wait.
Oh, sorry.
Let me be on the screen, ma'am.
Oh, sorry. I have
Please, I want the cloud.
is this better?
Oh, excuse me. Wait. Hold on.
Oh,
I'm coming down. Hi. You come here often?
Oh, damn. Oof. Ooh.
Looking good. Stop slapping with your ears. I'm going to fucking sneeze in a second. Stop it. Keep hitting me.
Sorry. Not.
I love you, Tricky. You're great.
I love you, too.
You're great. I'm enjoying our times together.
I am too. I love you. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, dude. This is so fun. I'm so glad I got you on for this one. I'm glad we rescheduled it and didn't just be like, hey, next month.
Yeah, because like I knew that I just didn't realize what time I would have to do today. You know what I mean? So I was just like, oh, well, I'm sure that we could do it later.
I actually like doing these at 8 p.m., honestly. So this is good because I always have more energy later at night.
Okay, well, we do this all date nights the same time. I become smaller.
I do it based on what people what people need for their time.
Nice car.
Which is great.
I usually get more energy that Joel does have a nice cock. Huh?
I polish it every night.
Yeah, then polish cock.
Sounds so weird coming from me.
What? Why?
No, just I saying the hearing polished. Other people say everyone hearing other people say polished cock just sounds so strange.
Why, though?
That's my line.
Oh, sorry. A nice doll cock. Is that better?
Anyways, I really here comes the prayer too. Oh my god. I should show Tricky Hun. Ignore them. They like to pray sometimes. I'm not wearing the nun outfit, guys. There's no reason to pray right now. God, I really want my next outfit to be a... I really wanted the office lady to win because I just want to wear pants. I think pants are really hot.
Pants are very, very, very
sexy. I'm tired of wearing a dress. I want pants.
Well, why don't you just, like, choose?
Because it's more... It's interaction bait.
I see.
I'm playing the right way, not the way that I want.
I see. I have a pharaoh outfit coming and then a mermaid outfit
I fucking love that.
But I would like to have Megasus one day.
I've been drawn as a mecha a couple of times.
I enjoy mecha stuff.
Do you like Gurren Lagann?
I have never seen before.
That's my favorite anime.
I need to watch it.
That anime got me through depression at least 17 times in my life.
I do really need to watch it. I've only seen, like, I watched Gundam. I was obsessed with Zoids, and then I love Zoids.
That was one of my hyper fixations. I bought a Zoid and then got into Gundams.
Yes, I have not gotten into Gurren Lagann yet, just because I just haven't had time.
it's 24 episodes, really fast paced.
It's actually a lot shorter than I thought it was.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a fucking new anime where it's like it's seasonal. It's just 24 episodes.
Oh, okay, I see.
I love Gurren Lagann. It's, I think, my favorite anime of all time.
Mm-hmm.
It's so good. It makes me so happy inside.
Yeah, happiness.
If I ever feel sad, I just am like, row, row, fight the power.
I'm like that with Fruits Basket and Yu Yu Hakusho. I love Yu Yu Hakusho so much.
Never seen either, but I know about Yu Yu Hakusho.
Yu Hakusho,
and I know about Fruit Basket. Metabots was a hyper fixation for me for a while.
Oh,
I loved Metabots. I collected a lot of things. So I collected Bakugan even before my hyperfixation. I collected Pokemon cards, Yu-Gi-Oh cards. I only bought because I wanted the hot women cards. I collected I collected all the game boxes back when I was a kid because I used to sell games to GameStop so I could afford other games.
Yeah.
But I would always keep the boxes because I thought they were really cool. Not much besides cards and stuff like that. I really enjoyed cards and like Bakugan.
I love cards. I had a lot of Pokemon cards, but my Yu-Gi-Oh collection was huge because I'm gonna sneeze. Are we gonna come out? It's not gonna come out. What a pussy.
Bah! Did it help? I'm sorry for you getting cucked midstream.
It didn't come out!
Don't talk. If you talk, it makes it impossible to come out. Thank you for the $20, Tempest! It's okay, I'm just gonna assume it's Tempest.
Thank you, Tempest!
Dude, are you okay?
Yeah.
Did the cuck still fuck with you?
Yeah, my nose is... It was like... Kinda... Okay, I'm good now. I think I'm good. Okay. It was kinda burning.
It's gotten over. It's okay, I get anyway, how you feel.
I had... I also collected Hot Wheels.
Yo, I had some when I was like really young, and then I realized I don't care about cars.
I just loved like, okay, so I had like a Hot Wheels Turbo Racing game for N64, and like my brother and me would pretend that we would be the cars. So whenever the Cars movie came out.
Yeah, fuck you, yeah.
It's like, what? We came up with this before you were a thing.
Did you watch the Hot Wheels show as a kid? Because there was a Hot Wheels anime that I watched growing up.
I do remember the show.
They would like go to different dimensions or some shit.
Yeah. And then they made another game for the GameCube about the show, and I got that as well.
Did you play the recent Hot Wheels game that was like apparently really good?
I have not, but I really want to. Is it on Steam?
I think so. I saw that it was really popular, but it kind of died down really quick too.
Ooh. Okay, I'm gonna try it because I like Hot Wheels.
Wait.
And then I named my
yeah,
things Hot Wheels too.
You named certain wait, what? You named certain things that you have Hot Wheels?
Well, I don't collect like the car Hot Wheels anymore, but yeah. I collect other things that I also refer to Hot Wheels.
Is this a sex thing?
No.
Yeah.
I was about to say, what? I'm trying to think of what toy sounds like. What would be named after a Hot Wheel and make sense?
It's my Hot Wheels Turbo Racing.
Because it wouldn't make sense to name a dildo a Hot Wheel. Unless the balls are wheels. A vibrator's not a Hot Wheel. What fucking toy is a Hot Wheel? I don't understand what this means.
It is a vibrator. Because I could go on turbo mode, and I didn't know what
to say. Is that the only thing that works with it?
I panicked on stream once, and then I was just like, okay, it's Hot Wheels now. So now it's just Hot Wheels.
When he drives his Hot Wheels over your coochie. What if somebody like brings out a tech deck in the middle of sex and he just busted his nut and he started tech decking on my stomach?
Did you have tech dudes? They were fire.
I did. Do you remember the little beanie guys, the little magnet bean guys that you would flip over with the tech decks?
I remember them.
That was so stupid. So Mighty Beans, that's what they were called.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, that was such a good time. Simpler times, indeed.
Chat, I beg of you, I know you're VTuber watchers, so this is a long shot, but any of you that do have sex, please buy a tech deck, and the next time you bust a nut, just tech deck on the on your significant other's ass. Do a little kickflip on their ass.
And then make dinner on an easy bake oven afterwards. That's how you really know. Man, I want to do some tech deck on someone. Can I do tech deck on?
yeah, you can tech deck. You can tech deck on my pecs.
Okay, perfect. Perfect, perfect.
I'll give you specific permission for that.
Oh, perfect.
As long as you never call them boobs and you say they're pecs, then do it.
Oh, yeah. So, okay. Tech deck on the titties. I mean, the
you lost
techies.
Your privileges. It's too late.
I my brain just...
You already fucked it up and lost your privilege. You said tits instead of pecs.
Pecs.
My masculinity will not be insulted like this, Tricky.
I meant pecs. You have such wonderful, wonderful masculine, sharp pecs.
Mm-hmm. Fine.
And I would like
forgive
to
peck
on them.
I forgive
Please.
You. You have to clean off the barbecue crumbs, though.
Crumbs?
It was from the barbecue chip story.
You didn't have to say crumbs. That means it's crusty.
It's not crusty. It's porcelain.
But you said there's barbecue sauce on
there. No. Like, not sauce, barbecue chip crumbs.
Oh.
Lay's barbecue chips.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll
eat
them.
Sauce. Come on now.
I'll eat them off of your pecs.
Shaking my head. Tricky, when did you start swearing as a kid? Because I have a specific story with this.
I didn't start swearing until I was
an adult. Hi, Tempest. Really?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for all the subs and money today, dude. I really appreciate it. Keep supporting Tricky. She deserves it. Thank you for being an awesome dude.
Thanks
for having a fucking fat cock, dude. Meet me after the stream, like I said. I'll be at the Denny's parking lot. Anyways. When I was 14, something in me snapped, right? And I was just like, I want to swear. And I went up to my mom and while she was watching the Super Bowl with her significant other at the time. And I was like, Mother, can I have permission to start swearing?
Oh, I have a swear like that too. Okay,
and then my mom was like, yeah, sure. And then I said, fuck, out loud. And she was like, okay, you're so stupid. And then I started swearing from then on.
Funny.
She gave literally all I had to do was ask, and she was like, yeah, go for it. But if I did it before then, she'd be like, how dare you? All I had to do was ask.
Usually they appreciate stuff like that, because I do have a story of this. It happened a long time ago. Like, I was still in middle school.
Yeah.
It was during a hurricane that I had to, you know, prepare for.
Yeah.
And usually for whenever it's time for hurricane season, like, you have to go to the store, you have to get, like, candles, batteries, blah, 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 blah. And then my grandmother, whenever she was still living, was like, oh, okay, Tricky, you need to get anything that you need, because we're not going to be able to leave. Once this hurricane hits, we will not be able to go anywhere. And I'm like, I don't need anything.
Oh, no.
And then she's like, you know, there's not going to be electricity. Like, we can get, like, a really cheap portable DVD player or something. Or, like, we can do that. And I'm like, no, I don't need it. I'm a big drag. And anyway, hurricane happened, yeah? Knocked out all the power lines, everything like that, blah, 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 blah. On the second week of not having any electricity.
Oh, God. She's already cracked.
Yep. We didn't have electricity for 2 months, by the way.
Fuck. Dude, I could not imagine had that happening to me today.
It was
for one week, sure. I'd be like, okay, I'm relaxed. I'll play. I'll just hope that my fucking PSP is charged enough, and it would be charged for like maybe a few days.
Yeah.
2 months, I could not imagine. Because
it was something.
I read stuff. I don't read physical books either, and you can't charge your phone either. If it's no internet, I could survive for 2 months because I have games, but fucking nothing, no electricity.
What I did, I had like a cassette player that was battery powered, and I recorded myself. This is how I knew that, like, whenever I became an adult, I'm like, okay, I love to record myself and then let people listen to my tapes, and I love to, you know, entertain people, because I would entertain my parents by just recording myself. But anyway, like, week two, I'm like really bored, and yeah. I'm like, oh, what do I do? And I was like, Momo, and she's like, what, little baby tricky? And I'm like, do I have permission to say a cuss word?
That's so cute.
And then she's like, go ahead. And I'm like, damn it.
Oh my God,
I didn't say anything but damn it.
You're so cute, bro. What the fuck?
I'm like, oh damn it, I really wish I would have gotten a portable DVD player.
When I asked for my permission, I think the first swear word I said was shit, not fuck. I don't think I had the balls to say fuck yet. Mine. Yeah.
Yeah, the reason why is like my brother and me, if we swore at all, my grandmother would wash her mouth out with soap.
I had that happen to me once, but it was because I was like a either a 7 or a 10 year old, and I was saying it directly towards my mom because I was being a little brat. But. Yeah. I never would like direct swear words at people in general. I would just say fuck, like the fuck.
I remember I felt like such a Chad whenever like I flipped off my parents the first time, and then.
Oh my God.
I was like, ooh, I got in so much trouble, dude. Like,
if I was mad at my mom instead, I would never swear at her. I would just like call her by her first name.
Sometimes it's even worse for some parents. It was way worse.
My brother, I learned it from my older brother because he was the one doing it. I only did it once, and then I felt bad immediately, and I stopped.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Because she would get sad. So I didn't do it ever again. My brother did it for a whole year. And he was just being, he was like that for a whole year. And I did it for one day after he did it. And then I was like, I don't like how this feels. And my mom is sad now, so I didn't say it ever again.
Yeah. Because I was a pure kid, honestly. Sometimes I would be a brat, but I didn't really like making people sad. And
yeah.
Whenever I would get mad, I would be like the biggest brat, but I would feel really bad about it. Like, there was this one time that I stole like a Rudolph movie from my little brother, and I was like, hey, 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 yeah, stole that Rudolph movie.
Kid.
Yeah, and then I watched it because, well, another thing to take into consideration, I didn't live with my brother, my half brother and me, like my family's very complicated, but so he would visit me a lot, and then that's whenever I stole it. And then there was a day and I watched it a few times, and I felt guilty, and then I called him. I'm like, I have your Rudolph movie, by the way.
Oh my God. Tika, thank you the raid. I hope you had a good stream. Thank you for rating me, Raiders. My name is Forrest LeMaid. I used to be a sexy... I'm going to do the shortened version. My name is Forrest LeMaid. I used to be a sexy sack of man before I died, and my soul got trapped inside the body of a sexier female doll. He and pronouns, but if you still use that pronouns in the 21st century, you can think of me as a bisexual's wet dream. Sexy male voice trapped inside of a sexier female body. Thank you for coming by. I'm on a date with my friend Tricky.
Hiya.
Welcome.
Hiya.
Yeah, no, I can't. I did it. It was my first one. That was your first stream? Good job. Thank you for the raid, then. I appreciate it.
Hope you had a good first stream, then.
Baby Streamer. God, do you remember what your first stream is? Because I'm trying to remember mine.
Mine
was 7 years ago, so I'm trying to remember it.
Mine was... My anniversary will be in July, so let's see. It'll be almost 6 years was my first stream.
Wow.
I've been on YouTube.
How do you remember that, dude? I was 7 years and I don't remember mine. What is the cutoff, 7? How the fuck do you remember yours from 6 years ago? I don't even know what the fuck I streamed. I streamed Overwatch or some shit.
I streamed PUBG. And
oh god,
the reason why I remember so much is because I was so afraid of streaming, and I had a lot of friends who were like, please, you got this, like, you were made for this. I'm like, I don't think I am.
God.
I don't think I am. Like,
that's
I was
so cute
used to doing
though
YouTube.
That they were giving you so much encouragement. My one form of encouragement was my English teacher saying, hey Joel, you ever thought about making a YouTube channel before? You're a pretty funny kid. And I already had a YouTube channel at the time, and I was like, thank you, that's so sweet of you.
Yeah, and you're a wonderful streamer, Joel, so like, they knew.
Stop.
They knew.
I'm gonna fucking kiss you on the lips, dude, don't even.
Yeah, yeah, and kiss me, bitch.
I'm gonna tongue punch you in the throat.
You're a wonderful streamer, accepted.
It just goes, like, the voice gets deeper and deeper, and it's just like... Was that a ghost I saw? No, there's no ghosts in my house. Nope. What is wrong with you guys? Besides, the only ghosts here are Tricky. Literally, look at the fucking house, you idiots. There's literally nothing there.
There's nothing there.
I've been saying this for a while. I look at the fucking background, and there's literally nothing. See what?
I don't see anything.
Why are your eyes closed? Well, your eyes are closed, Tricky.
Oh, yeah. I don't see anything.
There's a ghost right there. In the middle? I don't see anything in the middle. You guys are full of shit at all times, I swear to God.
Wouldn't it be creepy if there's something behind me?
Is there something behind you?
Oh. Maybe.
Is there?
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know. I can't see behind you.
Why not?
I don't know. I just can't.
This is your house.
We're two-dimensional.
Just turn around, forehead.
We're two-dimensional.
Just turn around.
Stop making fun of me for not being able to turn around. You can't either.
Every time.
That's fucked up. That's fucked up.
Just turn around.
Just turn around, forehead. There's a ghost on the balcony.
Oh, is there?
I don't see anything up there. Oh, you guys are stupid. My chat's so dumb, I swear to God.
There might be something.
Where?
Perhaps. Oh, I think I... Ooh. I don't know.
Anyways, ignoring all them. My chat's been doing this for a while now. Every time they look in the background, they're like, oh, you're a ghost. And it's like, shut the fuck... The only ghost in the house right now is Tricky. Look at her little ghostlings.
It's like ghosties.
Little babies.
Zyboo, Cupid, and Diaboo, and Booba, or Ouroboroboom, and Chillaboo, and Spoodle.
Spoodle. They're so cute.
I love my bubbas.
I want to eat them. They look like Peeps marshmallows.
They're very squishy. I will admit that they're very squishy.
Do you ever just like chew on one of them?
I've chewed on them before.
They look chewable.
Yeah.
Like a dog
and
treat.
And huggable. Yeah, whenever they don't want you to touch them, then you just go right through them. But whenever they do, they're like...
Do you... Okay, this is going to sound weird, right?
Okay, what's up?
Wait, first off, you, what does this say? Yuan Zhao Jie... Kuailet. All I know is Kuailet is like a celebratory thing, but a big happy lantern festival. Anyways, do you have you ever... This is a strange thing that I've always wanted in my life. Hear me out. Human dog treats. They're not dog treats. It's just something to chew on. You won't eat it. You just chew on it.
I feel like I would actually really enjoy that.
Like gum, but it's a hard stick.
Because, like, I have a very bad chewing problem. Like, I used to chew on styrofoam cups all the time.
Yeah.
And I would ruin them.
okay, maybe not styrofoam, but I want a stick that I can just chew on. Because I've had licorice root, and it's just a stick that you kind of chew on. But I want one that has, like a different flavor.
Yeah, usually for my chewing needs, I just get beef jerky.
I know people say pen caps too, but I don't want it to be edible. I don't want to eat it. I just want to chew on it. Like, I don't want calories. I just want to chew.
Jerky.
No, jerky is like a fucking full meal. Because it's a giant piece of meat that's just dried. It doesn't take away any of the fucking calories in it. It's still
tastes good, and it's like...
A bag of jerky is about the same amount of calories as a full meal.
I just really, I'm craving jerky now.
I know. I had this jerky that I used to get all the time that was like Korean barbecue jerky, and it was so good.
I'm hungry again.
I know. Don't worry, y'all. I had a big fucking meal. I had the vegan curry stir fry that I told you about.
I guess you could technically just buy a dog toy and just chew on it yourself.
Yeah, but that they don't have flavor. They're just like rubber. I want literally like a stick that has flavorings on it that I can just get Joel a teething ring. No, I just want a stick to chew on that maybe has like a flavor on it.
They have flavored
sticks. I also want
that
gum that is savory. I want savory gum too. I want
that
like
last for 30 seconds.
I want gum that's like meat flavored. I want gum that's like pickle flavored. I want savory gum. I want barbecue gum. I want gum that isn't sweet.
Ew.
Well, what gum were you thinking of?
I thought you were meaning like gum that just doesn't lose its flavor for a while.
No, I want savory gum. I don't like sweets. I want savory gum. I want something to chew on that doesn't have calories that I can just enjoy the savory flavor of it.
Like pickles?
I just like pickles. You can ignore that part, but like anything works. Hi, Truck Chan!
Hi, Truck! Hiya, hiya, hiya.
Honk, honk. Wait, hold on.
Honk me.
Truck, honk the horn if you think that we're hot. It's like those signs that you put outside next to the actual truckers.
Can I honk for her?
Can I honk your horn, Chuck? Can I? Honk, 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 vroom, vroom, honk, honk.
Vroom.
No, I don't want mint either, chat. I mean, mint. If I get gum, it's normally like mint flavored now, but I want savory gum. Like maybe popcorn flavor or like anything. Like maybe the flavors that we put on chips.
I don't know about that.
I just want it. Okay. Gum without flavor it's not like it's fine, right? I just want savory gum. That's all I ask. Salt and vinegar gum? I would do that. I would eat salt and vinegar gum. Okay. Maybe not Cool Ranch gum. That's a little gross. I'm not a suburban white mom who's obsessed with ranch.
Have you had like the meat, like drinks?
Meat drinks.
Yeah, like there's a store that sells like all kinds of weird stuff like that.
Oh, like pickle soda?
Well, okay, again, like pickle juice and stuff like that doesn't bother me because
I drink the brine.
Juice.
I fucking swash that set. I drink that shit down.
Have you ever had pickle pops?
No, but I almost bought one on Amazon because I was looking for pickle stuff.
You can make them yourself. You can just get like a popsicle maker and just put the brine in it and then put it in the freezer. And then ta-da.
I would like that.
I used to do that as a kid. I love pickle juice.
I love pickles. Did you know, for people who can't eat bread, there's an alternative that's pickle sandwiches. And it's a giant pickle where they scoop out the insides and they put all the bread, the sandwich stuff inside the pickle. So it's like a crunchier sandwich.
That's interesting.
It's so good. I would eat Kool-Aid pickles, chat. I would try it. I've seen people do like pickles that are like sweet. I would try them.
Oh, Kool-Aid pickle?
Yeah.
What is a Kool-Aid pickle?
It's just pickles that are brined in Kool-Aid. So it's a cucumber, but it's brined in Kool-Aid.
I can't imagine that. I would have to try it before I.
I know. I would try a lot of these things though. I love pickles so much.
I just love cucumbers. Like I have one right here.
There's already sweet pickles. There's like gherkins. Yeah. There's like relish pickles. Those are sweet. What are you eating?
Cucumber.
I love you, Tricky. I can't believe she's eating somebody's leg live on stream. Chat, look at chat. My leg! My leg!
That's not even what I... Wait, hang on. Let me get a chat leg.
Do you have a PNG for it?
Mm-mm.
Oh, my God.
Not yet, but I'm going to have to.
This just reminds me of how ingrained SpongeBob is into our culture, Chet. SpongeBob is so ingrained in us and that we're all just making a SpongeBob reference right now and none of us are recognizing it as SpongeBob. That's celery.
No, it's chat's leg.
I've seen the videos. I know how sounds are made for games and movies.
touching that celery, Shakira.
Do you mind? I'm trying to make myself look smarter. Do you fucking mind? Can you not do that to me? Can you not downplay my existence?
I'm sorry.
Fucking hell. My leg! Has anyone seen my cat? Oh, wait. Where did my leg go?
Sorry, it was delicious. Thank you for your leg, chat. Thank you for your sacrifice.
That's so fucked up. Oh, my God.
Oh, gee, Willikers, I hope there's no carnivores on stream. I hope there's no big, strong carnivore that comes in and eats my leg.
Not talking about the third leg.
I mean, I could also, never mind.
Scarlett, thank you for the 20 gifted subs. You have big dick, a big heart, even bigger wallet. Thank you for the generous donation. Big love, Scarlett. I love you. I'm glad that you're getting your bonuses, Scarlett. I appreciate it. Oh, fuck. The carnivore's here. I love that you can, that you're so good. You're so good at, like, voice acting, like, noises and animals and stuff.
Example?
Little bleps and, like, the noises that you do. And then, like, obviously all the Pokemon. I don't know. I feel like you're, like, for example, when you worked on Sen's music video, lore video.
All the gremlins.
Yeah, you're just so good at it. Like, I would never be able to make that noise ever in my life, even as a child. You're really good.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. It's I'm so good at cool. making weird, well, weird sounds, I guess.
No, I mean, that's a skill. There's a lot of stuff like that in voice acting nowadays where they need people to do that.
Thank you.
Yeah, best screech. I like Tricky's voice a lot. She's a natural born voice actor. Not just for Pokemon. She just has a nice voice for voice acting, too.
Thank you. What the fuck?
Can you say Peter Piper packed a pack of pickled peppers?
Peter piped a who? And take this
with a grain of salt. Peter piped what now? In the end, even if it wasn't, oh my god. Sound engineering job is wild and extremely impressive. Thank you for that Bitty's visual. Ooh.
Thank you.
Zombie sounds or somebody gargling on yogurt. Ugh.
I can do
Peter Piper Pat. What was the one that I was really good at? I had one that I can turn into a rap god for. Chat, do you remember what it was? Hold on, I sent it to somebody. Oh, the Bitter Batter. That's what it was. Betty's Bitter Batter.
Betty's Better. Fuck.
What was it? Betty's. Does anyone have it? Or should I look it up? Let me grab it and I'll copy and paste it. We're gonna turn to rap gods, Tricky. Are you ready?
Okay.
We're gonna fight the limit of how fast I can talk. I mean, I'm mad that I only got 25 seconds of my fucking raid intro. I swear I've gone 23 before. Betty Botter bought some batter, but the batter was bitter. Yeah, it was something like that. I was really good at it. No. It's like a paragraph. Oh, here it is. Betty Botter bought a bit of batter, but she said the batter's bitter. Fuck. Betty Botter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my batter, it will make my batter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my batter better. So she bought a bit of butter better than her bitter butter.
Yeah!
And I was able to do it really fast. So it's like, Betty Botter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my batter, it'll make my batter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my batter better. So she bought a bit of butter better than her butter bitter. Better bitter batter. Fuck. No, I fucked it up at the end. Shit.
That's impressive.
I tried. I'm really good with my tongue twisters. Do you want to try? Would you
like I am so bad at tongue twisters. I am so
yeah,
bad.
Yeah, but it's fun. Try it.
Okay, I'll try.
I'm peer pressuring you into doing it live on stream.
Wait, but ooh.
Don't
Betty
laugh.
Botter, okay, dude, I laugh at everything. Okay, Betty Botter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter bitter. But I put it in my batter. I will put my butter bitter. Butter bitter. Butter bitter. Butter bitter. Butter bitter. Fuck.
Rap God.
How do I do that? I can. I,
Betty Butter bought a bit of batter, but it made... Anyway, hold on. I'm going to try it again. I'm going to try it. The chat's moving, so it's fucking me up. Okay, I scrolled up. The chat won't move now. Betty Butter bought a bit of... Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my batter, it'll make my batter bitter, but a bit of better butter will make my batter better. She put up... she put. That's so fun. I love these. I love this one specifically because it's so good because it sounds like you're... The bees just sound so satisfying. Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said butter... But she said... Fuck! I get it like once, and then every other time I fuck it up.
Oh, it's so good though.
Oh my god.
Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter bitter. If I put it in my batter, it'll put my batter. Wait, batter bitter? Oh shit!
Yeah. Fuck!
Packet.
Shit!
Okay. Wait. Fuck! I can't.
You can do it. You can do it.
Wait. You have to go. I can't smell. Wait, I can't smell.
You want me to go so you can do it?
I'm angry. Hang on.
Okay. Deep breath.
You can't do the who. It's gonna make me. Okay. Here we go. Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter bitter. If I put it in my batter, it'll make my batter better. But a bit of better butter will make my batter better. But she thought a bit of butter better than a bitter butter. Fuck.
Close.
I need to do it faster.
I do it slow and then speed it up. So it's like, Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my batter, it'll make my batter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my batter better. So she bought a bit of butter and then a butter. Put it. Fuck. Last line.
Oh shit.
Fuck.
Wait, why is this so fun? I don't get it.
It's weirdly addictive. This specific one is weirdly addictive.
Better bot. Fuck.
Not the first word, Tricky. Not the first word.
Help.
Oh my god.
Help me. Save
Send
me.
Help. I'm Send dying. Call somebody.
Please don't call help.
I'm gonna help. Die.
Oh, there we go. Death. Oh.
Oh my god. It's so fucking fun. Do you think it's the bees? Just saying B words is fun.
I think it has to be because, like, even though.
Because I hate Peter Piper.
That one annoys me. Yeah, like, that one's not fun.
Peas aren't funny.
This one's
funny.
Like, let's see. What if we ooh-woo it?
Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter's bitter. If I put it in my bladder, it will make my bladder bitter. But I put the bladder butter will make my bladder bitter. So she bought a bit of butter, better than her bitter butter.
Is that what you wanted for me?
I think you're gonna do it.
Is that what you wanted? Is that what it
was? That was perfect. That was good. Clap. Big clap. I didn't expect you to do it.
It's really easy to do. Can you do it in ooh voice? Do you think it'll make it easier for you?
Let's see.
Let's get it. She put the ooh outfit on.
Fuck.
But she said the bitch butter, but I put it in my butter, it will put my butter bitch and put it on.
Do you think I can do it like really fast? Hold on.
Okay.
I'm gonna do it ooh and fast. All right.
Okay.
Butter, but she said the butter's butter. If I put it in my butter, will make my butter butter. Put a bit of butter will make my butter better. So she bought a bit of butter and better than a bit of butter.
It sounds like you're saying bladder.
That's so stupid. This is so cursed. Holy fuck.
And they call me a wap god.
Dude, I can't even do it fast in general. Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter better if I put my in a bowl. Put me in a shithole.
Oh, you almost did it! If you can't do it, I'm locking you up in jail. You're going in the cage with the rest of chat.
Is that a promise?
No! No!
Okay, I'm kidding. Wait, let's see. Let me get the
That's so stupid.
Betty Butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter better if I put it in my batter. It will put... Wait, where am I getting put?
Oh, ew, no, wait. There's a put in there.
Oh, okay. Wait, better butter, but... But... Better butter, 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 butter,
butter, butter. Better butter, 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 better butter.
Better butter bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter bitter. If I put it in my batter, it will make my batter bitter, but a bit of bit better, better, better. Fuck me in the asshole.
Do you think if I gave you like a beat, it would help you?
100%. If I had a beat, bub-up, I would absolutely
bub-up,
be able to do
bub-up,
it.
Bub-up, bub-up, bub-up. Just like that. That's in the background. You got a real shit fucking beat happening
wait,
in the background.
Wait, what was that? Bub-up.
That was it. That was the beat. Oh, that, what, do you want me to do a Boots and Cats?
That might work. Please cut out. I will hear us.
Wait.
Better butter, bought a bit of butter, but she said the butter bitter. If I put it in my batter, it will make my batter bitter. But a bit of better butter will make my batter better. But she thought a bit of butter better than a bit of butter.
Oh my god, my porcelain tongue is starting to get fucking tongue-tied. Oh my god.
I used to do rap.
Holy so. Shit. I used to, when I was in high school and middle school, I would write raps with my friends, and we would like rap battle each other over text. Yeah. Do you remember Epic Rap Battles of History? I used to write my own versions of them as a kid.
Yeah.
And then as amazing. I got older, I would listen to like Japanese rap like Takayan, and I would be like, I can do that. I could not. Oh no, my god.
I can't wait. I like you need to write a rap now, and we need to
right now.
Well, maybe not right now.
Oh my god.
But for like this year so we can get a porcelain bar.
Porcelain bars. Ooh, I don't know. I can't rap. I'm not good at writing things. I could probably do it, but I don't think I could write it. I doubt it.
I believe in you.
Oh my god. I have you one for you. Try saying... Nah, go fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself. I'm not reading that one. One for you.
Try saying Acousta Metellus Plectris 5 times fast.
Acousta homo what?
Hakuna Matata?
Hakuna Matata.
What a wonderful phrase.
Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing. phase. I don't know if I can. I don't remember this shit. For the rest of your days.
It's our problem.
Philosophy. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. So stupid.
Oh, but it's so funny.
Oh, fuck, dude. I love... There's some phrases that just become brain worms in my head, and they'll never come out. Like...
Understandable.
The fucking... Okay, so when I listen to music, right? I'll embarrassingly fuck up the lyrics, but if nobody's around, I'll still sing them, even if it's bad. Like with the
same thing.
The fucking thing that we listened to before, the salsa. I don't know Spanish, but I would fuck up the lyrics while singing it.
Yeah, I do the exact same thing. Like, usually whenever I'm practicing anything with music, I make up random words or just come up with a random language that doesn't even exist.
Yeah, but here's the thing. If I don't, I'll just do like noises. So like, let's say with the salsa, fuck, I forgot what the salsa sounded like, but let's say if I were to listen to the salsa chat, it would sound, hold on, I'm gonna listen to it real quick. Okay, so I got it. So if I'm listening to it, I'd be like, and then while they're talking too, I would still make the noises, but I wouldn't say the words.
I usually do that.
I usually do that most of the time. Mostly just because like it's just easier and I just it's still fun to sing.
It is. It's even thinking. If you're not making the if it's just fucking caveman noises, it's so fucking fun. I love music. My body is an instrument and I'm playing it with my tongue, baby. Oh wait, that'd be a good pickup line for a musician. Is your body an instrument? Because I want to play with my tongue. Wait, no, that's not. I feel kind of gross now. That was a little too nasty. It's not better than the plate one. I was clever and it was funny. The porcelain plate one was a great pickup line, and you're all L. You all have an L for saying that it's not.
Oh, that's because we had to add plate to it.
I think it was great. Hey, baby, are you hungry? Because I got some porcelain plates for you to eat on tonight. That's that's the one that I said. I said the word plate.
You did not say plates. No, you didn't.
On the show. On the show, I said plates. And then I was immediately, one of the other contestants, Conte, was like, but you're not made out of plates. So I'm like, shut up.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I lost points because of that.
But then
I'm
when
so
you
mad
you
about
said it
that.
To me, you left out the plate part.
Every fucking dating show I've been on, I get fifth place. Fucking Fillion's dating show, Kenji's dating show, fucking RPR's dating show. When am I going to be the one who has to, people have to impress, huh? I'm tired of being the one who's impressing people. I want to be the one who people have to date.
I want to be the person too, right? At one point. Because I've got second for Fillion before.
Oh yeah, we were on the same one.
Mm-hmm. It was the one to get
was
Numi.
It new? Oh no, not I wasn't on the Numi one. I think we were. Were you on the Bao one?
Oh, I was on the Bao.
Yeah,
one.
You were on the Bao. Wow, you were both forgetting this. I wasn't on the Numi one because I had a stream that day. Because Fillion streams on the exact same fucking days that I stream, which is why we can never collab.
Twice? Oh wait, no, I wasn't on the Numi one. I was watching the Numi one. I was in the Bao one.
What? Tricky.
I had a moment. Dude, I have ADHD. I don't remember shit.
Who won? That, it was Miune won one. When am I, chat, I'm saying it. I need to be, I'm better in a position of power in terms of the date night thing. So I think it would be funnier if they were going after me. Because then I can throw the stupidest fucking questions to them.
Yeah.
I guess everyone thinks like that, right? Everyone wants to be the one who has the suitors instead of being the suitor.
I want to watch that. I would watch that.
I'm still mad that I'm on fifth place every time.
I've only done one, but like.
You were really good on that one though.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, I don't care if I get rejected. I care that as soon as I lose, I know the other bitches that were contestants are gonna be like, "Yo, what's up, Mr. No Riz?" I'm gonna beat the shit out of them. I'm gonna beat the shit. I'm gonna fucking. The contestants are gonna wake up in the middle of the night and I'm gonna be standing over their bed with a knife.
Oh no.
What'd you say about no Riz? Why don't I cut off your Riz? Come here.
The word is starting to grow on me. At first I hated it because I felt like it just came out of nowhere. Yeah. I feel like I was having like a old person moment.
Most of the slang that becomes something that we assume is Zoomer thing is just like African American vernacular that like people just are like that's really cool and then everyone uses it.
I'm starting to hear it so much now that
are you like into it now or are you still kind of like sick of it?
I'm still kind of because I don't even want to say it out loud. I'm still like, but
that's
I
fair.
Feel like I'm going to begin to say it. Because whenever I first started hearing everyone say it, I'm like, bro,
here's how I decide things, right? As soon as I hear Geary say anything in terms of slang, I'm just like, all right, it's dead. Cut it off. As soon as I hear old lady Geary say anything in terms of slang, I'm just like, all right, no more. We're done. We're done. Stop using it.
Bless Giddy.
Yeah. I love her.
Bless. Big bless.
Yeah, I love Geary so much. I love all the VTubers are so sweet. I love all my friends. Ooh. Everyone's got such a nice personality and they're so cute. And I love everyone's outfits. Yeah.
I love everyone. Everybody's been so kind.
I every VTuber that I know, I just want to like make them a food, like make them sandwiches and then hand them out to them. And I want to watch them eat and it, like treat them like little chip, like little hamsters. I would say chipmunks, but I was like, hamsters make sense.
What's your favorite sandwich?
If I had to choose, dude, Italian subs. Hands Ooh. Down, an Italian sub with the oil and all the fucking, like the sourness of it. Oh my God.
Oh.
If I had to fuck a food, I'd put my dick inside of an Italian sub. That shit's so good. Fuck. Oh my God.
This is the second collab in 2 days that I've had somebody want to fuck a food.
If you had a penis, Tricky, and you had to bang and you had to like fuck a food, what food would it be? For me personally, crepes. I think crepes would fit perfectly there.
It needs to be something a little bit warm. Do you know those donuts that aren't like donuts, but they're like kind of long and they have
eclair? I know exactly what you're talking about. I've had the same thoughts. I'm joking. You're talking about eclairs.
That's one, I guess.
That's good. That's a clip. That's going on TikTok. My editor is putting that on TikTok. I'm never going to live that down. I'm never going to live that one down.
So you've already had those same fantasies, huh?
No, it's a joke. I just think it's funny.
Yeah.
Oh, what are you talking about? I plead the fifth.
Yeah.
Bro, it was a joke.
It was just a prank, bro. I don't want to put my dick in there.
Oh, my God.
Dude, if I had a willy, I would do so many fun things with a willy. Because, like, it seems so fun, but I want, like, a penis power-up because I don't want to have one all the time. I just want to be like,
so,
and then ta-da.
Obviously, women have it worse in terms of genitalia. But I will say, the one most inconvenient thing for men, balls, really annoying to sit down with and sleep with. Cock? Erections are stupid, bro. Really annoying. The balls is the main thing. It's super, like, because you'll be in bed, right? And, like, or maybe you're sitting down in public or whatever, and then the balls are just, like, in the way. And you can't just put your fucking hand in your pants in the middle of the public, so you just gotta, like, I'm just gonna deal with this now.
Do you have to, like, shift your body so it can, you like, do. Play marbles
I'm made out
pants?
Of porcelain, right? Not to break my immersion. I'm made out of porcelain. This is back when I was alive. Right now, I don't have to deal with it. I can just take my genitalia off, lock into the closet, don't have to worry about it all day. Back when I was alive. You see that? I didn't break the immersion there. I'm such a professional. Back when I was alive, you gotta shift. You gotta fucking shift all the time. Or always sit cross-legged or else you're just always gonna be it's like obnoxious. It's like such a minor inconvenience. And, you know, women have to deal with a lot worse things. But the minor inconveniences all just annoy me.
Yeah, I used to have like, let's see, I asked someone, I'm like, can you ride a bike? This was a long time ago though. This was, I don't know how long ago this was. I'm like, can you ride a bike?
They gotta be in the front. They gotta be in the front. Cushion?
So you have to shift.
Yeah, you gotta shift it.
If you just sat on it normally, you would get like extra cushion?
You know, any men in the chat ever... We're getting to weird territory. Any men in the chat ever accidentally sit on their own balls and just like scream in pain?
See, that's what I was wondering. I'm like, it happens.
It happens.
Oh.
It's really, really fuck. It sucks.
I'm sorry about your balls.
That's why some people will man spread. It's not a sexual thing. Well, okay, some men make it a sexual thing because they're freaks. But sometimes it's literally just like, I'm in the most uncomfortable position in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So my chat's like a solid half of everything. So if we're doing it by halvesies, I have 33% men, 33% women, and 33% non-binaries for my chat spread. So I'm like, I truly am the perfect pansexual, just wet dream or whatever. Men in the chat, you fucking, it's annoying, bro.
I would like to have like one day to just experience everything.
I want everyone to just have detachable. I feel like in the future, humanity should just make our genitalia detachable. Like, we should be able to choose whether or not to wear it. I don't want it. I don't want it on all the time. You can switch it. You can switch whatever genitalia you want all your anytime. You can take it off if you don't want any. That should be the next evolution. Science, figure it out. Make us have detachable genitalia so we can switch it around.
Oh, what about me?
What do you mean? Do you want?
I just take off my clunge.
Yeah.
How do I do that?
We just make ourselves ball jointed. Everyone should turn into a ball jointed doll. We should all turn. Oh. We should all be like me. Everyone should be like me with my customizability. I mean, Chad, I'm fucking perfect. I could fucking attach a knife down there instead of a cock. I could have a coochie that has a shredder built into it if I wanted.
Have you seen teeth?
Yeah, I could have coochie teeth. I have every kind of porcelain genitalia lined up. I could have a coochie with teeth in it if I wanted.
Oh, that's a terrible movie.
I'm living the good life, bro. I got the customizability. The modular functions of my body are top tier. I get a gun. If I fucking pelvic thrust, it shoots.
I actually would like that. That would be fun.
Swiss Army cock.
I want like the Austin Power titties where like my nipples go like boom.
You probably could. There's so many video games where some of the characters have fucking nipples that shoot bullets.
That's amazing. I like
so
it.
So weird. Oh my god. Yo, Kira, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. You have a big dick, a big heart, even bigger wallet, big love. Yeah, but
thank you.
My favorite monster girls are dolls because of that. Feel free to.
I'm just gonna drink right now.
Look at her go, Chad. Everyone look at her while she drinks. Look at her.
I'm just gonna... There we go. Now it's safe. No, shut up, Chad. Now it's safe. Dude, I'm loving it. Chad, and you guys could be drinking too by using the awesome power of Gamer Subs. Use code GAMERAID to get 10% off your order of Gamer Subs today, Chad, and get a delicious beverage that is not only zero carbs, zero calories, and zero sugar, but it's also all-natural caffeine with zero added fillers. It's lovely, it's keto-friendly, and you can buy... Wait, hold on, I did this wrong. Chat, you know Gamer Subs is keto-friendly, zero calories, zero carbs, zero sugar with no added fillers. That's right. Not only will it give you a long boost throughout the day, but unlike regular coffee, it does not make you have a nasty crash afterwards. Use code GAMER to get 10% off your order of Gamer Subs today. Use code GAMERMAID. I recommend the Shibuya Kaho's peach tea flavor and or the lemon flavor. I don't know. Do you have Gamer Subs or you advanced, GG?
I have a question.
Yeah?
Do you think that this emote looks like fondling?
What emote? What? Yes.
That's what.
Very much so. It looks like somebody's fondling some balls.
Yes! Yes.
It very much looks like somebody's getting fondled. Why? Why?
I don't understand, and I can't unsee it.
Why do you ask that? Is somebody arguing with you that it doesn't?
No, it's because I brought it up before, and I'm like, hey, does this look like...
It very much looks like somebody's fondling. It's going in for a little twickle.
A tickle?
God.
Is it normal?
What?
I don't like being tickled, but there's a lot of people who do like being tickled.
Oh, like sexually or just like enjoyment?
Enjoyment.
Because there's some weird shit out there. I don't like tickles. I don't like it. It makes me feel like I'm getting like murdered.
Yeah, because there are some people who are like, oh, don't tickle me. And then they get tickled and like, hee, yay.
Sorry, you reminded me of a TikTok of our...
What?
I saw a TikTok recently where a rat was getting... It's like a mafia TikTok with animals. And there's a little rat in the trunk. And he's like, what are you going to do to me, big guy? And he's like, he's all tied up. And the big guy's like, we just want to ask you some questions, all right? Don't fight back. And this will all be easy. And the rat's like, oh fuck, what are you going to do, tickle me? And the big guy's like, what? No, I'm not going to... What do you mean tickle? And the rat's like, oh fuck, he's going to tickle me. You hear that? He's going to tickle me. This guy's a tickler.
Is it tickle you?
It's so goofy.
Please don't tickle me.
Oh no, don't tickle me.
But no, I don't like tickling.
Me. Yeah, I don't like it when anyone touches me.
I wonder why that's a response in our bodies. Like, what the fuck is tickling?
I don't know. Because like, I like to tickle though. I will tickle people because it's funny.
What about head pats? Do you like giving head pats or getting head pats?
Both. maybe. I don't tell Chop.
I don't like getting head pats because I feel like it's going to ruin my hair. It's such a petty reason, but if somebody touches my head, I'm just like, fuck off.
I mean,
most people can't reach my head anyways.
Head strokes and like playing with hair is like one of my favorite things ever.
God, my mom used to play with my hair so much growing up, and I was just like, no, my hair, I combed it.
Well, like if I go out and then like I've made my hair all pretty, but I don't know if somebody would do it anyway, I feel like I would be like,
I like giving head pats. It's like like that. That's the emotion that I feel interpreted into noise.
Understandable.
Yeah, that's my favorite thing.
Yeah, but like, there's a thing that happens if somebody pokes me in the side. I make an eep sound.
Oh well, that's like a pressure point. And it's like you're very vulnerable on the sides. I remember kids in my school, we would go around, me and the boys would go around doing that to people, and it would just be like the most scary thing in the world. Because if someone, I just did it to myself. If somebody does it and touches like the two, the most vulnerable part of your body, which is like the two sides, you're just like, ah! And it's like, it doesn't necessarily hurt, but it's like, fuck, dude.
I eep.
Yeah, eep is a good way of describing it. But men in my school would go around and do it to each other and be like, fuck you, gotcha.
Gotcha.
Yeah, that was fucked.
Yeah, I don't like that. It feels so bad. It's like such a weird sensation.
It is. It's like the squishy bits.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, don't touch that.
It's like, oh my God, no. Get away from my squishy bit.
If anybody touch, oh.
Nothing. go on.
Say that again.
Nothing. I don't have squishy bits. I'm all hard all the time because I'm made out of porcelain.
You're hard all the time?
You gotta be rock hard to be able to rock hard, if you know what I mean.
Understandable.
Oh my God. Anyways,
we're talking about squishy and hard.
Oh God. Are you okay?
Yeah.
You gathering your thoughts? We're at the 3-hour mark, by the way. So if you, normally this is the end of the collab, but let me know if you're feeling tired, if you're hungry, you want to go get a snack, or you want to go eat food, we can end it here, or we can keep going. Either one works for me. This is the normal. Don't feel bad if you do want to leave, because this is the normal time that I normally end anyways.
Do you know who I am?
Twicky-wee.
Do you know how long my streams are?
I feel like I'm being threatened.
Oh. Do you know how long my streams are?
That's better. 14 hours. You do stream for a fucking long time.
Yes.
Do you have a schedule?
Nope.
Really? You just stream whenever you want?
Yep.
You're so powerful.
The only reason why is because like whenever I have like my sad days, or if I get like randomly angry.
You want to stream?
I will not stream.
Oh.
Because I will be mean.
That's true.
And then, like, I feel like my emotions come out a lot more. So, the last time that I had schedule, like, schedules in general for anything that has to do with live content, if my heart's not in it, I won't do a good job. And I'm going to bring the mood down. So, I always want to be at my 100%. So, I only stream whenever I feel like I am able to stream.
I get that. I have a schedule, because if I didn't, I think I would stream every day and I would just run out of energy really quick and get burnout. So the schedule's kind of there to keep me from getting burnout. But also, I have this deep-rooted fear that if I don't tell my chat when streams are going to be, they'll never know when I'm streaming.
Oh.
Maybe it's because I don't trust chat to be able to like understand schedules. I feel like it's like having a dog and you tell the dog like, hey, we're going to go out tomorrow. And then you wake up in the morning and the dog's like asleep. That's how it feels. Like I have to grab chat by the head and look them in the eyes like, stream Monday.
Yeah.
I'm just worried they won't know. I'm like, my deepest fear is like, I start a stream and like nobody joins because they either don't know I'm streaming or they just are like, ah, whatever. Bad timing.
Yeah. That's actually, your example reminded me of why I stopped having a schedule. Because if I say, hey, I want to stream on this day at this time, and if something happens, because life happens, I have a very hectic, like my IRL life is like,
yeah.
And like things happen, and then if something were to occur and I'm not able to stream, I get guilty. And then I will think about it for like the rest of the time. I'm like, I didn't stream. I didn't tell, like, I told them that I was going to stream. I've already said that I'm not going to stream. And they probably very disappointed in me.
I have a different, I have a similar thing, but a different reaction, I'd say. So I feel guilty, not to, because of chat. So I don't feel guilty that I'm not giving chat content. I feel guilty that I'm not growing. Like, I'm not putting in the effort. That's how I feel. So it's more like I'm mad at myself than I am mad at chat. Like, I'm not, I don't feel guilty that chat's missing out on content. I'm mad at myself for not taking my opportunities that I have.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Because
I think my chat wouldn't care because they're very sweet. But I'm mad at myself for not taking, like, the advantage of the opportunities that I have.
I can get that too, because if I don't work a certain threshold each week, I hear my pets. I'm gonna have to take
babies
out my doggo soon.
Well, when you do, we can end the stream there.
Oh, okay, but I'm gonna miss you.
We can hang out again.
But I have to meet like a certain threshold of work each week, or I will not feel fulfilled. Taking vacations for me is very stressful, weirdly, because like everyone needs vacations. Everyone needs to decompress and just be a person for once.
Yeah.
And just relax.
As much of a meme as the word touching grass is, it's really important to ground yourself into reality by having either an IRL friend to hang out with or just like going outside once in a while. Especially for me as somebody who never goes outside that often.
Yeah.
And I only have one IRL friend because I'd never had a full job to make friends with or anything. It's very important or else you get too into your own head. Speaking from experience.
Yep.
Learn from your mistakes.
Yep. I still do that. Like, I'll have like my moments where I'm just really enjoying streaming. And I will stream every single day for like 8 hours at a time.
Yeah.
And then I forget that I've been doing that for 2 weeks straight. And then I'm like, I feel like I'm dying all of a sudden.
Yeah. It's even worse because sometimes if you do feel sad, because you don't have a support system of like IRL or being able to ground yourself to reality, you feel like anything that happens online is the end of the world.
Yep.
Happens a lot. You gotta chat. Do your best to go outside and be friends with people.
And even if, like, just going outside and, like, going to the store or, like, doing something that you might enjoy, like, finding new hobbies is very, very healthy for everyone. Because, like, ever since I got a dog, like, I finally touch grass, like, every single day now because I have a dog now.
Pets and also would help a lot, yeah. I notice a lot of people, pets always make everyone feel healthier and happier.
Because like I'm always exercising with my dog now, and now I feel like I have to go outside, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like I have a cat too, but you know, she's an indoor cat, very well, most of the time independent, but also kind of needy at the same time. But
I need
she
a
can't
cat
go outside. Cats are wonderful as well.
I really want one. I've been wanting a cat for years. I'm like trying to mansion proof. Because you can see the mansion's all fucked up. I need to mansion-proof this place before I get a cat.
Yes, you must. But your cat might actually like going up and down the stairs and being on the railing because mine does.
Ah, oh, fuck. They got 9 lives.
Well, yeah, they have. My cat has never like fallen or anything like that.
I've seen so many videos of cats fucking landing on their goddamn faces. They're idiots.
Oh, no.
All the TikTok videos of cats making a jump and then falling and then meowing because they're like, you didn't see that.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm gonna get a cat and then I'm gonna name it Chat. I think it'd be a really cute name to name my cat after the amalgamation of my viewers.
That's cute. Come here, Chat.
Come here, Chat. Chat, stop shitting on the floor.
The chat cat.
Chat, no, that's the furniture! Chat, get off the table!
That's so cute. I actually love that so much.
I think it'd be funny. If I ever have them and the chat comes up on the stream and like stands on my desk, I'm just like, chat, fuck off. And they start hissing or meowing.
Yeah.
I think it'd be funny.
I just want my cat to love my dog because like she's only been around for like a few months. My cat has been around for like 7 years. So she's like so used to being the only pet. And she's like, who's this demon? And also I like platonic hugs. I saw somebody ask me that. I like hugs.
I like hugs too. I'm an affectionate person. Yeah.
I am too.
I'm physically affectionate because I grew up like that. But also at the same time, if I can't be, I'm just like very verbally affectionate. But like in an aggressive way. Like, fuck you, I love you. Fuck, you're so cute. I just want to beat the shit out of you because of how cute you are.
It's like, yeah. love you, fucker.
My words of affirmation are like, I'm going to fucking punch you in the gut because of how cute you are. Fuck you.
Yeah. I love.
Yeah. Touch starved homies. Oh my God.
My dog. What? I hear my dog.
Is he scratching?
Yes.
Oh, I can hear him whining. Wait, I can hear him whining in the background.
Yeah. That's Capri.
Oh, that's so cute.
Yeah, she might need to go out.
And you do you have to go for a walk with them?
Yeah.
That's fine.
Otherwise, she'll shit on the carpet.
We'll do another collab soon. I enjoyed being with you.
I love you, too.
I love Twicky.
I love you, and I had a wonderful time.
I really enjoyed this. I'm glad that we got to hang out again.
Yes, we need to do it more often. I know that, like, oh my goodness, our schedules. all so busy all the time.
My streams are always busy, but if I'm ever in your chat, that means that I'm free. Just so you know.
Okay.
So if you ever want somebody, if you need, like, a spontaneous motherfucker to come in and hang out, I'm there. Mm-hmm. Every time I'm in somebody's stream chat, that's when I'm free. I'm not doing anything.
Yeah.
But yeah. Thank you, Tricky, for coming on. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for coming on to Date Night. Another one successfully down. Chad, if you guys like Tricky, please go check out Twicky Wee. She's very sweet. She does a lot of streams, and her streams are very hyperactive and very long. So a good chance if she's streaming, you'll find her throughout the day to enjoy and watch. She is one of my faves to watch at 5 a.m. when nobody else is online.
Thank you so much. Thank you for lurking, all the love and affection. Thank you again for having me.
Yeah. Do you know the way out of the mansion, or do you want me to like call you an Uber? I know you can like fly and everything, but I don't know if you get tired like if you're lazy, like I can call someone to pick you up.
I wasn't thinking of catching your house on fire again.
What the fuck? What, are you gonna light it on fire outside as you fucking leave?
No.
I'm gonna go to bed tonight and there's gonna be smoke inhalation killing me.
Yeah.
What do you mean? Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, get out of my house. Get out of my house.
Goodbye, Joel.
Bye, Twicky. Thank you for hanging out.
I'll see you in the next one. Yeah.
I love Twicky.
You have that door. Remember, you have to fix that door.
Did you break my door?
No, you have another dimension here. In the
mountain. Oh, I still can't see what you're talking about, so I'm just going to leave that up to you.
Understandable.
I didn't realize there's a fucking dimensional pocket.
I break everything. I'm chaos. But I love you, Bunches. I hope you have a good rest of your stream.
I will.
And I will hang out with you soon, yeah?
Yeah. Bye, Tricky. I'll send you a nice DM later saying thank you for being on my stream.
Thank you, Bunches.
Goodbye. Oh, wow.
Bye-bye.
She really did disappear through a fucking dimensional pocket. What the fuck? Christ, I can still hear her. Oh, God. What the fuck? Is it gone? Are they gone? Are we free? Holy shit. What the fuck happened there? Chat, remind me not to fuck with that one. That's scary. How the fuck does that even happen? She's in my goddamn walls. Oh, well. Thank you guys for watching the stream today. Hope you guys had a good time with Dana. You guys like that? That was a really fun one. What the fuck? Maybe there is a ghost in my house. All right, I gotta take my dick out. I'll be right back. Chat, thank you for watching the stream. Hope you had a good time. Big love to you. Maybe I'll put my dick away after that one. What?
Hello there.
Obi-Wan? Anyways, thank you guys for watching the stream today. Big love, everyone. Hope you enjoyed. This was a really fun time, and I'm really glad that I was able to hang out with Tricky. I enjoyed myself a lot. And Lightning McQueen! What the fuck? Hey, Chad, look, there's lightning. That's so stupid. And it... Jesse Pinkman. This ghost is really weird, huh? What was that? What was that now? Beavis and Butthead! I feel like I'm learning new things about this ghost today that's trapped inside my house. I feel like... Is it all ogre now? Is it all ogre now? I'm just gonna continue on. I'm gonna ignore the ghost now. Thank you guys for watching the stream. Hope you had a good time today. Big love to you and hope you enjoyed our date night with Tricky. She's been a lovely guest. And if you guys like Tricky, please go give her a look. See, she's a wonderful streamer and a wonderful friend. She's very sweet and very cute. And go be nice to her and give her lots of love in her own stream. I'm ignoring the raptor. I'm ignoring the ghost. I'm ignoring the ghost. I'm ignoring the ghost. I'm going to take out my dick later and I'm going to fucking go find that ghost and give it a real fucking... I'll let it know what I think of that ghost later. Anyways, hope you enjoyed the stream. If you guys want to see me anywhere else, I have a... What is this ghost, Numi? Why are they bringing out fucking fruits to kiss now? If you guys enjoyed the stream, I stream 4 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Next stream is going to be on Monday. We're going to be playing Dead Space, the remake. So be sure to come by on Monday, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, to watch me play Dead Space. I'm going to run around the entire ship with my dick out and look for an incredibly sexy creature to... Fan of Pokemon, I see. Anyways, if you guys want to see anything else besides streaming, I have a TikTok, I have a Twitter, I have a YouTube channel, I have a VOD channel on YouTube, as well as I have a Discord server, and you can buy merch of me on the merch store. We're going to be announcing a, in March, we're actually going to be selling new body pillow of me, as well as a titty and an ass mouse pad that you can rest your hands on. It's really hot, and the person who did the art for it is my art mom, so it'll be really nice. Other than that, you can also buy my plushie on the website in the chat. But that's about it for today. I love you guys a lot. I hope you enjoyed the stream, and I'll be back on Monday with Dead Space, all right? Next week is another fucking banger of a week. Because chat, next week Monday is Dead Space. Next week Wednesday is Potionomics. Next week Friday we're beating Dead Space, but we're also having the tits stream. And the next week Saturday is Date Night with Cottontail. I see the ghost is also a VTuber fan. But yeah, that's about it for tonight. I love you guys! Thank you for watching! And one little heartfelt note to leave it off on. Thank you everyone who came by to the stream and raided me and came to watch the stream. As always, there's always so many options of people that you can watch on stream. All the VTubers, all the people that you can enjoy, but you chose to come watch my stream and it means a lot to me that you did. I love you guys a lot. Thank you for making my day better and thank you for hanging out with me. It always makes me happy to have so many people come into my chat and just vibe with me. Tricky! I love you! Thank you for the 10 subs! I'm gonna make out with you later. Mwah, 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 mwah. But yeah, Tricky, you were a wonderful guest, and I'm really happy that you're here with me. I love you guys a lot. Thank you for being here, and I will see you all next stream on Monday, all right? Bye-bye, everybody. We're going to go and raid Cinder because I love Cinder, and she's a good friend of mine. So be nice to her and give her lots of love. Other than that, I'm going to head out. Turn the music up. Mwah! Thank you for supporting me. We're going to keep growing, chat, and by the end of the year, hopefully, I think we'll probably hit 1,000 average viewers. We got this, homies. Have a good rest of the night. Have a good rest of the weekend. Get lots of yummy food. Thank you for all the subs, the bits, the donos today. And thank you for just being an overall wonderful community that I can rely on. I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye! Go give love to Cinder! And go give love to Tricky! I'm gonna head out. Bye.